Have you or a loved one been injured in an accident? Are you struggling to recover fair compensation? Look no further. At Phillips Law Firm, the experienced personal injury attorneys will fight for your rights and get you the justice and compensation you deserve. They handle a wide range of cases, including car accidents, slip and falls, medical malpractice, and workplace injuries. Justice is a phone call away, so don't wait. Call today for a free case review. Call 1-800-JUSTICE or visit justiceforyou.com.
Looking to give the gift of pleasure? Add a little high heat to keep the desire burning. Or maybe you just need a little self-care. Come to Lovers for the best lingerie and toys to keep things hot this holiday. Save 20% on your purchase with Lovers Afterglow Rewards. Just mention LOVE20 at one of our 18 Western Washington locations. Offer valid with free Lovers Afterglow Rewards membership until November 30th. Some exclusions apply.
Your home is going into foreclosure and you feel like a financial wreck. You don't know where to turn for accurate information. I'm bankruptcy attorney Travis Gagne. Let's talk about some legal options. If we work quickly, we can propose a plan to save your home, modify the loan, or in many cases even eliminate your second mortgage. The consultation is free. I've helped hundreds of people just like you make informed decisions about whether to save their home or exit it on a reasonable, organized timeline. The chapter you choose sets the tone for the next chapter of your life. Please contact me today at ChooseTheRightChapter.com. That's ChooseTheRightChapter.com.
99.9 KISW, The Rock of Seattle. There's a new Netflix documentary about the man that can bend it, David Beckham.
Uh-oh.
Great, great soccer player. But there's a clip in this documentary, in case you really don't care about watching it. This clip is going viral because in it, David's wife, who is Posh Spice, otherwise known as Victoria.
Yeah, she has a name, man, Victoria Beckham.
Yeah, and in this, she tells the interviewer that she grew up working class. And David, listening from the next room, sticks his head through the doorway and calls her out for lying.
I'm very close to my family. Yeah, I mean, I think also we both come from families that work really hard. Both of our parents work really hard. We're very working class.
Be honest.
I am being honest. I am being honest.
What car did your dad drive you to school in?
So my dad...
What car was it?
It's not a simple answer
what
because...
What car did you get your dad to drive?
It depends.
No.
Okay, what in car? The 80s, what? My dad had a Rolls Royce.
I love David Beckham.
Yeah, that's fantastic.
I love that he just called her out on this. He's probably listening in the other room. He's like, my wife is just full of ass.
Well, I mean, they called her Posh Spice. I mean, and it makes sense that out of all of them, she was probably the one that was really posh.
They also called one Baby Spice. She wasn't actually a baby.
Right. Oh, she was my baby.
Scary Spice. I don't know about you guys, but she wasn't very scary. I thought she was very attractive.
Oh, I was. I always wondered if she would hurt me.
Now, Sporty Spice, yes, she did look like she enjoyed a couple of sports.
I love that Posh Spice really was posh. I mean, yeah. She's like,
what's honest.
Yeah, it's a difficult answer. What's difficult? Your dad drove a Rolls Royce. That's not a working class car.
That's the best part. What kind of car did he drive? Well, it's a difficult answer. No, there's actually an answer to this question. What kind of car did he drive?
Now, if she said they worked hard and left it at that, that's okay. I mean, they probably did work hard to get what they had. But then when she said working class, that's a whole different type of person you're talking about.
He is the hero of the day.
Yeah,
because
he is.
He didn't care. He's just like, I don't care what you're talking about, what you're doing for this dumb documentary. You're not lying to people.
That's fantastic. That is, and I love that made it in there.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because you think maybe Victoria would have been like, you're going to cut that out, right? You're not going to make me look bad. Too bad. It's my documentary. It's staying in.
He is truly one of like the most like handsome dudes I think I've ever seen in my life.
Oh my God. Every time I see him, I'm like, wow, that man is a beautiful.
Even like Vicky pulled up, I'm like, oh, he's aged well, too. This guy.
Yeah.
I mean, he could do no wrong.
Yeah.
He calls out his wife for lying. He's very handsome. It's ridiculous. He's living the good life.
He's very in shape. He has all the right tattoos.
He plays soccer.
You know what? I feel the same way about Baby Spice.
Yeah.
And I saw her recently on, like, she hosted some British baking show kind of things at one point. And I was like, oh, Baby Spice, you age well. You got all the right tattoos. I don't know if she has any tattoos. but she likes cake. And so, you know, that's
she
all
likes
I care about.
Cake. There you go.
So I said, didn't you wink at David Beckham once, Migs? Yes.
Yeah, you did. That's right.
You know, were you around for that?
No, I was not.
Oh, that's right. So when we went to the Super Bowl, for many reasons, that was a very crazy experience because mostly financially, it was a lot of money. But, you know, where we sat was in a really good section. We sat in the section where all the players friends and family were all at. So it's a decent spot. And I guess that might have been kind of wherever David Beckham, or maybe he was on his way to a suite, I'd imagine. But all of a sudden, I'm waiting in the stands. I'm waiting, you know, for some food and some drinks, and I'm in line, and I'm just like standing there. And all of a sudden, all this security detail comes out of nowhere. It's like, split the lines because it's so packed. So they're like, open up a lane, open up a lane. So they pushed a bunch of us out of the way. And so I'm like basically the first person that they kind of split. They split the sea. And all of a sudden, who's walking right by me is David Beckham.
Oh,
and
yeah.
I'm closer than you and I are.
Wow.
Like, and like we stop for a second. So I'm staring at David Beckham and he's staring at me. Good, just because, you know, he's walking. And I just look at him. I didn't know what to do. I didn't know what to say. I was just kind of like stunned. I'm like, I'm not even good at noticing celebrities, but I'm like, that's David Beckham.
Sure.
So I'm looking at him and I didn't know what else to do. So I just winked at him.
He does, like, you know.
I was like, it was like, it wasn't like a, hey, dude, what's up, kind of a wink. It was more like, I know who you are.
Yeah.
Don't worry, I'll keep it a secret, even though you have 50 billion security people getting you through this area. Oh,
so the wink was like, don't worry, I'll keep your secret. That's what the wink was. When you're in deer in headlights moment, when you get shocked, and you do the weirdest things.
I do.
Really, it's really fascinating, like with when you your wedding ring.
Here.
You just slide it over here.
Your brain stops. I get it.
Yeah.
I didn't know what else to do. Yeah. But I felt like I had to do something. We were looking at each other.
It's better than your wife's hot.
Yeah. Oh, he wouldn't have said that. Your wife's husband's hot.
You're hot.
Where's your wife at?
Yeah. Because if she's not around, I am.
We got room in our row if you want to sit next to us.
There you go.
Yeah. I like that you had good seats, that they were close to where people walked by you that were famous.
Well, I mean, it might have just been that he was just walking by that section, but they were good seats. But I got to imagine he was going to a suite.
Oh, yeah. He's not going to hang with you because he's not going to hang with all the winkers.
Yeah. I wonder what he was thinking as he kept walking by. Like, did that dude just wink at me, and why?
He probably, you know, figures, oh, there's a gay man that thinks I'm attractive, which has probably happened a lot to him.
Either that or, man, Vin Diesel sure is winking at me weird today.
Yeah, he maybe thought you were Vin Diesel.
Then he should have winked back.
Yeah, he was afraid, you know. He was like, did Vin Diesel just wink at me? He probably froze. This is the most awesome day of my life.
You know, like Jeep Wrangler drivers, they have the wave.
Oh, yeah.
So maybe like celebrities, like they have the wink.
We've got to watch the documentary. What if he talks about the time he was at the Super Bowl? What is the greatest time you had with a celebrity? A celebrity running? Well, I was at a Super Bowl, and then Vin Diesel winked at me, and I didn't know what to do. I felt like an idiot.
Well, he's probably a little taken aback. He's like, what happened to Vin Diesel? He really let himself go.
Yeah, we all have our days, mate. All right, I've got the headline of the day for you. A beer-drinking monkey was on the loose. You're welcome. All right, you'll probably get more info. Steve's got the Migs report for you at 6:17 on The Rock.
BJ and Migs, mornings on The Rock, 99.9 KISW.
We all know cats are intelligent. Felix Cat Insurance was able to secretly record two cats on a hidden microphone. Let's listen in.
Did you hear the one about the three dogs at the park?
That's old. Like four lives ago.
But did you hear about the new pet insurance just for cats from felixcatinsurance.com?
Of course. What do I look like, a dog?
When you're coughing up a fur ball. Yes. Listen, Felix Cat Insurance plans start at under $1 per day and are as unique as you and me. They call it whisker-to-tail protection.
Even furballs?
Even that. Remember the last time you had a furball? I made a TikTok. It went viral.
Oh, well, that's good. Wait, you're on social media?
There you have it. Felix Cat Insurance. Customizable coverage exclusively for felines. Sorry, no dogs allowed. FelixCatInsurance.com. Get it? Meow. Insurance is underwritten by Independence American Insurance Company and produced by Independence Pet Group. Pre-existing conditions are not covered. For all terms and limitations, visit FelixCatInsurance.com/terms.
99.9 KISW The Rock of Seattle presenting Foo Fighters at T-Mobile Park on Sunday, August 18th. Hope you've been listening all week because between 6 a.m. and 10 p.m. today, guess what? You're getting a code word. Once you get that code word, you text it 206-803-ROCK for your chance to win tickets to the show. You know, we've been making people wait for that code word. I think I'm going to give it right now.
You're going to do it now?
I'm going to do it now.
All right.
I'm going to do it live. That's right.
Do it live.
I got the code.
Do it live.
Yeah, doing it live. I got that code word for you right now. It's Everlong.
Ah. kind of weird code word is that?
I don't know. Maybe it has something to do with the band. I don't know.
All right, maybe. Yeah.
So text Everlong right now for your chance to win tickets. 206-803-ROCK. It's your shot at winning Foo Fighters. You want more info, go to KISW.com.
Well informed on the issues of the day? Not this guy. Live from the KISW News Center in downtown Seattle, this is the Migs Report.
Do it live!
Thank you guys, and thank you to Palace Law for giving us the Migs Report. And how about today? A very special day. It's Come and Take It Day.
Wow.
I don't know exactly what that means.
That's aggressive.
But come and take it.
Yeah.
Brother.
I feel like that is, yeah.
Maybe you're going to take some garlic because it's Garlic Lovers Day.
Ah, keep out the vampires.
And National Noodle Day. So come and take the noodle.
Come and take my noodle. That doesn't sound right.
Plus, a very odd day, and I don't really know the history behind it, but I feel like it's perfect for the Pacific Northwest. It's Platter Day, meaning everyone should wear plaid. Like
oh,
shirts.
I thought it was like bring a platter of something tasty.
No, plaid. Or oh. A day.
Platter Day?
Platter Day.
Okay.
Wear a plaid shirt, kids.
Yeah.
Today's your day.
Boy, this is a really great day.
Not the great, but it's Friday. Who cares?
Yeah.
That's all that matters. It's a good coming into the weekend. The weather's going to be nice. And at least we don't have to deal with a monkey that's on the loose.
Monkey's on the loose.
A monkey was on the loose in Indianapolis. And the best part about this monkey, its name is Momo. And a bunch of people spotted this monkey drinking a beer that they pulled out of a trash can.
All right, Momo.
So I don't know what was going on with Momo, if maybe Momo was drunk, because then one witness here, this person's name is Michael, was kind of explaining the whole situation.
I work from home, so I was in the middle of a meeting, and I just saw something run across my front yard here, and at first I thought it was a dog, and then realized it was the monkey that's on the loose, and saw it run right into that vacant house there, so...
And you got this drunk monkey. Apparently, it's a 30-pound monkey. It's the type of monkey that like it could go over 30 miles an hour.
Whoa.
It does kind of look like a dog.
Yeah, I would have thought that was a dog.
If you look at like a larger-sized dog, and then if you look close enough, then you realize, oh, no, that's just a monkey. And according to some reports, they believe that maybe it even bit a couple people as well.
Yeah, he's walking on all fours, and he's got, like, really light brown and white hair color, so that, you know, I think a monkey's, like, really dark-colored.
Yes.
So that's why I would have thought it was a dog, too.
Yeah, especially, and also, you're not just expecting to see a drunk monkey walking around your neighborhood.
And again, these people with these weird pets.
Well, here's a detective. His name is Bill Carter, talking about safely capturing Momo, because it was hard, because, like they said, this monkey goes 30 miles per hour, so it's not that easy to catch this monkey.
Obviously, there are concerns for public safety, but we also have concerns for the monkey. I mean, we didn't want anyone to injure the monkey. We didn't want the monkey getting hit by a car. Obviously, our officers are not going to know how to deal with a monkey. I've been in law enforcement 24 years. I've never dealt with a monkey.
Don't spank the monkey. Don't
yeah, that's what you're supposed to do.
Monkey.
You spank the monkey. That's how you stop it.
And you wonder about the owner. Well, yeah, the owner was given a citation for the latest escape of their monkey.
Why does the owner have a pet monkey?
That's what you got. And what, you know, maybe you need to like figure out what's going on inside the head of the monkey that needs to drink beer out of people's trash cans.
Yeah,
that sounds like a problem.
I don't know. I honestly, some people just you should say no. No, you can't have that as a pet.
As a kid, I always wanted to have a monkey as a pet.
Well, because you don't know how dangerous they are.
Once I realized that these things are pretty aggressive.
Yeah.
But how great would it be to just be like sitting on the couch and you're hanging out and you got your little button buddy that's a monkey just sitting there too watching the show.
Yeah.
We're both eating bananas. I don't know.
Okay, I'm done with this.
I've always wanted that, like where you invite some buddies over and they come over and you're just hanging out with your little buddy that's a monkey.
I think I'd have to walk out the door and go, okay, that's enough for me.
What if it's a well-trained monkey and you know it's not going to hurt you?
I don't know that about any animal.
What if I promise you that's not going to hurt you?
Yeah, that's not going to do it for me.
Who was the Dane Cook that had that one bit about, you do not want a monkey?
Oh, I remember that.
Oh, you got to listen to it because it's all about, there's always one anti-monkey person in the room and they have to be, you do not want a monkey.
Yeah, okay.
It's all fun and games until the monkey gets drunk.
Clearly, this monkey bit a couple people.
Yeah, they can rip your face off.
I mean,
depending upon how, you know, they're aggressive. Yeah, no.
I wasn't picturing like a 30-pound monkey. I'm thinking more like, you know, like 15, 20-pounder.
And I don't know. Is it more common in other countries to have a monkey as a pet? I don't know. Why do you? Because in this country, it never occurs to me like, you know, get a dog, get a cat, get a monkey. It's like, no, you don't get a monkey. What is wrong with you? Unless maybe other countries, that's what it's like, and it's like having a dog. I don't know. I've always heard monkeys are a pain in the ass.
Well, think about, like, you know, what was it, The Lion King, right? Remember that show? And then people were like, the crazy like kind of couple that was also involved with it, they were always like doing drugs and partying. And they were able to convince people to hang out with them because, well, they were like, hey, if you want to see some of our exotic animals? It's like kind of like an aphrodisiac to some people.
Oh.
Like, come on over and hang out and meet my exotic, you know, lion or tiger or monkey.
Well, if I can get some action, I guess I'll have to get a monkey.
Dude, I feel like if you're hanging out in a bar, I'm convinced that you can find somebody that'd be like, hey, you want to come back to my place? And they're like, well, why? Well, you got, I got a monkey at my house.
All right, Vicky, would that work on you?
I'd be like, is monkey a code word for something? You know, drugs or, you know.
What if they're like, they show you a picture of their monkey?
That's my real life monkey.
And they're like, hey, do you want to come over and hang out and pet my monkey?
If it looks like the one from Friends, I'm in.
Marcel?
Oh, yeah, yes. Marcel, of course.
I feel like that would do the least amount of damage, but still be very cute.
And one text has a very important question. Who's throwing away beer for this monkey to even drink?
Yeah, that's a good question. How's a beer in the trash?
Maybe they decide, you know, we're done drinking in this household. Let's just throw away the beer.
All of this is so bizarre.
It's very strange. Well, thankfully, the monkey is fine.
Oh, good.
And no longer biting people. Now, we can't say that the Washington Commanders are fine. I don't know if you watched Thursday Night Football last night.
I did not, but I was looking at the score updates, and holy cow, you're at home, you think you're having a decent season, and then...
And you're playing a team that hasn't won for a very long time. In fact, they haven't won for their last 14 games. They're on a 14-game losing streak that, of course, dates back to last season. But the Chicago Bears have not been very good. They haven't looked good this season as well. A lot of people are just like, this team just out and out stinks. Well... They beat the Washington Commanders, and they beat them pretty good. Oh, my gosh, 40-20.
Yeah, I guess Dick Butkus, man, they're going to see if he can die next week, too.
Oh, gosh. Too soon, man. Too soon. Sorry. May he rest in peace.
Sorry about that.
Just died yesterday.
Well, I think
Dick Butkus jokes.
He was a big inspiration, I think, probably for them yesterday.
So
one of the greatest Chicago Bears ever played.
You think the fans want to see another like iconic Chicago Bears person pass away?
No, they need to get Dick Butkus to die every week so they can keep winning.
Or they just have to keep throwing the ball to DJ Moore. My goodness, this guy had 8 catches, a career-high 230 yards and 3 touchdowns.
Nice.
I'm not a fantasy sports guy, and I don't know if anyone really had them on their team, but if they did, holy smokes, you just racked up some points.
Makes me feel better as a Seahawks fan, because we have to play them this season, the Commanders.
Yes.
So it's nice to know, like, okay, because, of course, having to play that entire division, I mean, we got lucky, we got away with the one with the Giants, because I feel like the Eagles and the Cowboys are not going to be easy for us.
Real quick to go back to the story about the monkey, because someone just texted us, and I can't believe no one on the show even picked up on it. I didn't refer to it as the Tiger King. I referred to the show as the Lion King. And someone said, which version of the Lion King did you watch, Steve?
Oh, yeah, you're right. You did say Lion King, but I was tracking. I was totally tracking that you meant Joe Exotic.
I was totally thinking you meant some sort of, like, internet porn spoofs, and I was like, I'm not going to ask. I really don't want to know.
Oh, sure.
Wow. You said Lion King, but then I know you did, but then you went to Joe Exotic, and so I just said, oh, yeah, my brain didn't pick it up either.
I don't know if you guys are getting hit with allergies right now.
Oh, God.
Yes.
So I can't even focus. Yeah. Yeah. It is hard. My eyes feel like they're going to pop out of my freaking face.
Yeah, sorry about that, buddy.
What in the hell is going on?
I don't know what is this season what's going on? I don't know this to be an allergy season.
My left eye is watering nonstop.
It's been so bad, and it like I think I'm okay, and then all of a sudden my girlfriend mentions allergies, and immediately I start sneezing. I'm like, yes. What's wrong with my brain,
dude? Right now it's insane. Like I feel like someone just like injected like lemon into my mind. Like you know, like that, like yeah. That when you get that like that soury kind of effect from
it
like
sucks.
Lemon juice.
You look like you're crying, man.
Well, I'm really torn up about Dick Butkus. Nah, he passed away.
Yeah, BJ made insensitive jokes. I get it.
I mean, I know a lot of people knew him for being, you know, obviously a great football player, one of the two great Hall of Famer for the Chicago Bears. Also, interestingly enough, he forever played in Illinois. Like, he played high school football in Illinois, college football also, and then, of course, he played pro football in Chicago.
That is pretty amazing.
That's kind of a cool little backstory about him, but I knew him. Also for his acting skills.
Acting!
He was in My Two Dads.
Yep.
He was also in Necessary Roughness, Any Given Sunday, Johnny Dangerously, and most importantly, Hamburger, the motion picture.
I do not know that one.
You don't know Hamburger, the motion picture?
I'm glad. I feel like I'm glad that I don't.
It's one of 1986's greatest films.
Yeah, I feel like, I'm glad I don't know.
You should watch it.
Yeah, you should watch it yourself.
I will.
Good.
What's his eyes start to?
Yeah. I wonder what Rotten Tomatoes says about that fine movie.
Look up Hamburger the movie.
Yeah, Hamburger the movie.
Yeah. What does Rotten Tomatoes give?
I know nothing about this movie.
I'm going to go 25%-ish for the critics, and I'm going to go 60% for the audience.
How do you do, Vic?
So there's only one review for the tomato meter, so it's at nothing.
So the critics don't even want to watch it, DJ.
Yeah, it's so old. It doesn't even have a picture on Rotten Tomatoes. Like, nobody cares. But with over 250 ratings, the audience gives it 52%.
That's not bad.
That's not
close
good.
Close to what you said.
It's considered not fresh.
Yeah. We got a lot of apologies with Seattle sports figures. I don't know if you know that. Jamal Adams, he just apologized for his outburst after his concussion. I feel like everyone should give the dude a pass.
Why would of course he wants to get back in the game. Who cares?
Some people are mad that he was yelling at the on-field neurologist because, you know, he didn't want to get out of the game. And he put up a thing on his Twitter that just said, "You did everything right when you realized I was concussed. I apologize for any negative energy I brought your way. I'm thankful for your patience watching that replay, and I realized I wasn't myself in that moment. You're a real one and serve a great purpose that benefits the NFL and so many players."
Do you have to apologize for things that you do when you have a concussion now? He Dude. Has a concussion. I mean, of course he's going to be not in his right mind. He has to apologize for that?
I saw some people on Twitter like, "I can't believe he's blaming the concussion for his aggressive behavior." It's like, that's why. Like, if you've ever had a concussion, sometimes you have no idea what you're even doing. Especially a concussion like that where you just got rocked hard in your head during a football game.
Have you heard of CTE? I mean, that's what they're saying. Aggressive behavior and horrible stuff happens because too many head injuries in the NFL. It's the big controversy, which is why we have concussion protocol.
DJ, Johnny Bunch of Numbers on Twitter knows more than all of us.
Yeah, okay.
All right, and also Jerry DePoto from the Mariners, he apologized for his comments.
Yeah, Jerry. Talk about the nerd in the room that just doesn't know. He tried again. He tried again to explain his 54%.
And you know what, though? I think he did it better. He's like, "Look, of course we want to win all of our games. I'm just saying that a team that consistently is a 54% winning percentage over several years eventually becomes a powerhouse of a team." I think that's kind of the vibe he was trying to give. He even said, I cracked dumb jokes and that was bad. I wasn't really going to be like fire him for those comments. I think fire him because his team doesn't go to the playoffs ever.
Well, I will just tell you, here's the thing. It's an overly smart person, which, look, and I think that's a big problem in society. Overly smart people don't realize that the room just doesn't get it, and because they don't realize it, they really alienate a lot of people. Jerry DePoto did not make any friends, and his apology also, in my opinion, didn't make a lot of friends either. I'm not real happy with him right now.
He needs a laugh track at his press conferences.
Yeah, I mean, his joke was horrific, and you know what? You got to know that, Jerry. You got to know you're not the jokey guy. Stop trying to be the jokey guy.
He said, "I did a poor job of trying to convey what I thought, and I feel badly about it." He could have blamed it on a concussion.
You know something? He'd still get yelled at. You know, people just going to yell at him. I'm yelling at him anyway because I'm just a bitter Mariners fan right now.
Weather today, 72 degrees, going to be our high. It's going to be sunny as well. Thanks to Beacon Plumbing, Heating, Electrical, Septic, and Mechanical for giving us the Migs Report, and that's what's up.
Yeah.
And screw you allergies.
Sorry about that. I still don't understand what the hell we can be allergic to right now.
Unless everything.
There used to be ragweed back in the East Coast that killed me this time of year. But October...
How stoned is that ragweed get?
Well, the first frost is supposed to help you. That's what I always waited for. So maybe when the first frost happens, it'll kill whatever the hell it is getting you guys. I get mine. Vicky and I get ours mostly in June. But I have had a fuzzy head. And so maybe that's the allergies. And I didn't know that's what it was.
Well, I knew Danny was complaining about it for the last few days. And I think Vicky even was saying something about
too,
it.
I
was
like, yeah, I feel like very itchy. And I've been randomly sneezing like over the course of this week. Yeah. It's not fun.
Yeah, I was like, well, that sucks for you guys. And then today I come into work and all of a sudden there's just waterworks on my eye. Just my left eye, too.
Oh, that ain't good, man. Hopefully it doesn't mess with your drainage system, because I have that going on right now. My left eye, I have a drainage problem. There's a little hole in your, if you look at your eyelid, and there's a little hole in there. And if your tear, if that gets blocked up, your tear's got nowhere to go. I didn't know that. I found that out of my latest eye thing.
Well, thanks for throwing that in the back of my head.
Sorry. I'm just like, you know.
You're like the WebMD guy. I go on there just to see why I stubbed my toe and why it still hurts. And then I think I have foot cancer.
Yeah, well, you've got foot cancer in the eye. I hope you're going to be okay.
Yeah.
Yesterday,
can somebody drain my eye, please?
Yeah. Yesterday, Steve, Mr. Leaky Eye, got this one right.
What is the name of Ariel's tropical fish best friend in The Little Mermaid?
Sebastian?
No.
Flounder?
Yes.
That's it. Good job. I wouldn't have known that. Would you like a shot at beating Steve? All right, you got it. 206-803-ROCK. We're playing Beat Maze at 647 on The Rock.
Today's podcast is brought to you by bankruptcy attorney Travis Gagne, who's ready to answer your questions about bankruptcy. Travis, is it true that if you filed for bankruptcy once, you can't file again?
Even if you filed bankruptcy before, you can almost certainly file bankruptcy again. Different types of bankruptcies have different time limits between filings. In Chapter 7, full bankruptcy, you can only file Chapter 7 once every 8 years. However, you can always, almost always file a Chapter 13 case. Chapter 13 cases can be filed immediately following a Chapter 7. They can be filed immediately following a prior Chapter 13 case. Chapter 13 is a reorganization plan, so there will be some type of monthly payment, but it's based on your budget and your ability to afford that payment. So Chapter 13 is an option in almost all cases, even with a prior bankruptcy filing.
Thanks, Travis. If you have more questions about bankruptcy, you can reach out to Travis anytime at ChooseTheRightChapter.com. That's ChooseTheRightChapter.com. Thanks for listening.
From the very beginning, your kids mean everything to you. That means you do anything for them, especially if they're at risk. So when it comes to type 1 diabetes, screen it like you mean it. Because even if just one person in the family has it, your child is up to 15 times more likely to get it, too. Screen it like you mean it. Because type 1 diabetes can develop at any age. And once you get results, you can get prepared for your child's future. So screen it like you mean it. Type 1 starts long before there are symptoms. But one blood test could help you spot it early, before they need insulin, and could lower the risk of serious complications like diabetic ketoacidosis or DKA. Talk to your doctor about how to screen for type 1 diabetes, because the more you know, the more you can do. So don't wait. Tap now or visit screenfortype1.com to learn more. Again, that's screenfortype1.com. Screen it like you mean it.
This holiday season, make your journey memorable with Travel Centers of America, where our motto is simple. Return every traveler to the road better than they came. Avoid any hassle and stop at our one-stop shop for all your holiday travel needs. Fuel up, indulge in delicious snacks, and dine at one of our full-service restaurants. Hit the road with peace of mind knowing we've got you covered. For more info, go to ta-petro.com. Travel Centers of America, your road to happy travels.
Some companies are big, others are small. To Robert Half, their hiring needs are equally huge. At Robert Half, our specialized recruiting professionals elevate their expertise with proprietary AI tools to transform candidate discovery, assessment, and selection. Whether sourcing talent locally or in any geography that works for you, Robert Half can pinpoint hard-to-find candidates in finance and accounting, technology, marketing and creative, legal, and administrative and customer support. At Robert Half, we know talent.
Transit is better with an Orca card. Here's why. One, it's easy. Just tap and pay your way onto Metro and all other public transit around the Sound. Two, your tap shows us when and where you're riding the most, so Metro can serve you better. And three, Orca cards are for everyone. 18 and younger now ride free with a free youth Orca card. So what are you waiting for? Get an Orca card. Tap for transit and make your ride count today. Visit kingcounty.gov/tap for transit.
Have you been in an accident that wasn't your fault? Feeling overwhelmed and unsure what to do next? Look no further. The personal injury attorneys at Phillips Law Firm are here to help. Phillips Law Firm understands that accidents can turn your life upside down. That's why they're dedicated to fighting for the compensation you deserve and to making the process as stress-free as possible. Don't wait any longer. Call now, 1-800-JUSTICE, or visit justiceforyou.com.
Looking to give the gift of pleasure? Add a little high heat to keep the desire burning. Or maybe you just need a little self-care. Come to Lovers for the best lingerie and toys to keep things hot this holiday. Save 20% on your purchase with Lovers Afterglow Rewards. Just mention LOVE20 at one of our 18 Western Washington locations. Offer valid with free Lovers Afterglow Rewards membership until November 30th. Some exclusions apply.
Your wages are being garnished. We can stop that now. It's hard enough to pay your bills when things are good, let alone when a big chunk of your take-home pay is gone before you even get your check. I'm bankruptcy attorney Travis Gagne, and I can stop the garnishment and get the creditors off your back immediately, often the same day as our consultation. Both Chapter 7 and 13 provide bankruptcy relief, but choosing the right chapter is crucial. In a free consultation, we can create a plan to get your finances back under your control. The chapter you choose sets the tone for the next chapter of your life. Please contact me today at ChooseTheRightChapter.com. That's ChooseTheRightChapter.com.
99.9 KISW, the Rock of Seattle. It's our Loud and Local Band of the Week, and this week, it's Green Apple Quick Step. Loud Local Band of the Week, Green Apple Quick Step. You want to find out how to get their music? Steve's going to let you know.
I mean, they've been around forever. Well, I said been around forever. They're around for a long time. They broke up, and they get back together every so often. And big reunion show that's happening tomorrow night at El Corazon.
Yeah, and if you would like all the info, just go to the BJ and Migs page of KISW.com. That is also where you're going to find information about a great show called Loud and Local. Sunday nights at 8 o'clock, two solid hours of great Pacific Northwest music. Bands like Green Apple Quick Step. Katie's jumping.
We made it through another week, you guys.
Yeah, we did.
And last week, we discussed how we still wear Seahawks stuff, even though they weren't playing till Monday. And I know it's a bye week, but I see I'm the only one in this studio rocking Seahawks stuff. And now I'm confused.
I know. I don't blame you. I saw you this morning and I thought, oh, yeah, she has a point. I mean,
yeah, y'all are a bunch of hypocrites.
She's right. The Seahawks aren't playing Sunday, but why aren't we wearing...
Full disclosure.
Yeah.
This morning when I woke up and I was putting on my clothes and I put on my shirt, I'm like, okay, yeah, my jersey's still in my car. I'll just throw it on. I was like, I'm not going to wear it just to mess with Sarah and see if it actually works.
So I'm pleasantly surprised that I was right.
It worked.
Yeah, he trolled you.
I noticed, especially because last week you were like, I'm getting all my money's worth, so I'm going to wear this jersey all the time.
I was fully intending to, and I just said, nah, I want to see how Sarah reacts to this if she does it all. And
love it.
Well, you predicted me, so clearly I'm the number one Seahawks fan here. Okay. So
hypocrite, yes. Yeah. Troll, even more.
I'm going to tell you right now, I think that these guys made weird rules up. It's either a blue Monday or a blue Friday, depending upon whether they play on a Sunday or a Monday. And it's a blue Wednesday, or it's a blue Thursday when they play on Thursday Night Football.
No, it's always blue Friday.
Yeah, no, it's not.
And what if it's a bye week? You just forget about them?
No, it's not always Blue Friday. Steve, I don't know where Steve gets that. It's like,
Wait, find me the rules of blue days.
You find me the rules. They call it Blue Friday for a reason, but if there's no game, then you're not... We don't wear... But it's not Blue Friday when it's not football season.
It could be if you want it to be.
Yeah, it's not going to be.
I'm just disappointed in all of you. Okay?
Oh, so you're... Don't be mad
at
me.
I'm done with y'all. You're not wearing Blue Friday either.
It's because it's not Blue Friday. Steve makes that up just to troll you.
To be honest with you, I thought you were wearing like some kind of cool, quirky Seahawks shirt right now because I saw green.
Oh, no. Yeah, that's nothing to do with the Seahawks.
That looks very board gamey to me.
You're absolutely right. It's a board game shirt.
I'm done with y'all. Let's get to our contestant, Seth from Puyallup. Seth, are you there?
Yeah, I'm here.
Seth, are you wearing Blue Friday gear?
Nope.
You know what? I'm not.
Wow.
I'm just excited to be talking to the number one Seahawks fan.
Thank you, Seth, for understanding.
Yeah, you're right. I mean, I got a Kraken hat on, and it's blue, but it's not Seahawks.
All right. Well, Steve, get out of here.
I have a blue pen.
I hate you. I hope you lose so bad today.
Wow. Hate is a strong word.
For those playing at home, Seth has 60 seconds to answer 10 questions. You can pass all you want, but you'll only get 3 guesses per question. Are you ready?
Oh, I'm so ready.
In the thriller Carrie, the blood of what animal gets dumped on Carrie?
Pig.
Yes. Which vegetable is served with eggs Florentine?
Carrot.
No.
Pass.
What is made by white blood cells to help fight off infection?
Little, like, green army men that, like, fight the infection off?
No.
I don't know.
During what Aerosmith song does Steven Tyler use a sugar packet as a maraca?
During which era?
Aerosmith song.
Oh, man. Good grief. I always thought I was going to beat Steve, but I got to pass again.
How many cups are in a quart?
Four?
Yes. Danny McBride plays four. Kenny Powers in what sitcom?
Oh, man. Eastbound and Down.
Yeah. What retail company uses the slogan, save money, live better?
Save money, live better. Kit Kat. I don't know. Pass.
What is the name of the MLB team from San Diego?
Padres?
Yes. Rebel Yell is a hit song by who?
Rebel Yell! Youngblood! I don't know.
No!
Oh, no.
Seth, you got four correct.
I respect that answer.
Oh, four! Oh, man.
Hey, it could be worse.
Yeah.
It could be better.
It's a double deuce. Yeah. It's a double deuce.
Yeah.
Exactly.
It could have been better, though. Yeah.
Well, I'm still rooting for
it. It could have been better. Good grief.
Yeah.
Steve, are you ready?
Go Hawks.
Exactly.
Yeah, right, yeah, okay.
In the thriller Carrie, the blood of what animal gets dumped on Carrie?
The blood of a cow.
No.
Blood of a sheep.
No.
Blood of a deer.
No.
No.
Which vegetable is served with eggs Florentine?
Asparagus?
No.
Vegetable. Green beans?
No.
No, sir.
No. Potatoes?
No.
No, sir.
What is made by white blood cells to help fight off infection?
Super serum?
No.
Pass.
Wow.
During what Aerosmith song does Steven Tyler use a sugar packet as a maraca?
Oh, Sweet Emotion.
Yes. How many cups are in one quart?
Four.
Yes. Danny McBride plays Kenny Powers on what sitcom?
Eastbound and Down.
Yes. What retail company uses the slogan, save money, live better?
Walmart.
Yes. What is the name of the MLB team from San Diego?
The Padres.
Yes. Rebel Yell is a hit song by who?
Billy Idol.
Yes. How many groups of amphibians are there?
Four.
No.
Three.
Yes. What is made by white blood cells to help fight off infection?
Half and half.
No.
Half and half. Nice.
You get seven correct, which, unfortunately for me, is a win. Seven, four.
Let's go.
Man.
All right, Seth.
But I wish I could have done the number one Seahawks fan better. I'm sorry.
I wish you could have, too.
All right. Well, you try again, though, Seth. You got a good attitude.
I'm the best.
You don't deserve this. Not a true Seahawks fan.
And the first three were really tough for you, so I thought...
Turned it around.
You did. You really did.
Just like the Seahawks.
Yes. Carrie, the blood of what animal gets dumped on her is pig.
Pig.
Yeah.
Which vegetable is served with eggs Florentine?
Is that spinachy?
It is.
That makes sense.
And what is made by white blood cells to help fight off infection?
Antibodies?
Yes.
Woo! Together we would have had a perfect 10.
Wow. How about that? Well, I wouldn't have got so many of the other ones, though. I couldn't think of Eastbound and Down. I was so mad at myself. I'm thinking Vice Principals. I'm thinking of the Righteous Gemstones.
Oh, man.
I'm like, what the hell's the name? Because I know it wasn't either one of those.
Yeah, my husband loves that show. I think he wants to be Kenny Powers.
I can see that.
Right?
Yeah, he's got that hairstyle going.
Yeah.
Let's be honest, though. Danny McBride, everybody, like every role he plays is Kenny Powers, really.
Yeah, he's so good, though.
Yeah, he's good, but that character, he's like Will Ferrell. It's like, it really is. Kenny Powers is in Vice Principals. Kenny Powers is in The Righteous Gemstones. There's a little variation, subtleties to it, but it's really always like the same character. But I do love the character he plays, but it's pretty much the same.
Yeah, it's always entertaining.
Yeah. All right, well, if you're having relationship issues, you got problems at work, any other random problem where you need some advice, we're here for you. Call us, text us now, 206-803-ROCK. It's Help Wanted. We're going to do that, 717 on The Rock.
BJ and Migs, mornings on The Rock, 99.9 KISW.
This holiday season, make your journey memorable with Travel Centers of America. Visit our one-stop shop for all your holiday travel needs. Fuel up, get snacks, and dine at one of our full-service restaurants. Hit the road with peace of mind knowing we've got you covered. Travel Centers of America.
Is your relationship going sideways?
Have a family issue? Problems with your coworker?
Do you need advice? We're here to help. No problem is too dumb. No dilemma is too silly. This is Help Wanted with BJ and Migs.
99.9 KISW, The Rock of Seattle. Help Wanted. This is where you, the rockaholics, have been texting, messaging, phoning,
asking for a little bit of help with from your friends. If you can get by with a little help from us. And it doesn't matter, relationships, problems at work, or anything else. Even if you think it's dumb, we are here for you. Call us, text us, 206-803-ROCK. It's Help Wanted.
Ooh, I don't think I've ever asked this question before in my entire life, but would you like to talk about boyfriends or trombones?
As long as nobody named Rusty as part of either
there
one of those.
There are no Rusties.
Is there any?
No. Good. It you. Is a rust-free trombone.
Okay, thank you. Then I think I'm ready to venture into this land.
So which one? You want to do trombone?
Let's do the rusty-less trombone. Let's do it.
The more you say trombone, it's hard to say. Trombone. All right. Well, this involves somebody who's a parent, and their kid is playing that instrument. So yes. It says, my son's a wonderful, passionate fifth grader. Last year, he was encouraged to take up the trombone. He's an enthusiastic band member. He loves to practice, and he wants to perform for all of us in the family. There's only a couple of problems. He's not very good at it. He's horrible, actually. And the sound of his playing drives all of us crazy.
Yep.
The instrument squawks and creaks. Our dog starts howling. And I find myself cringing and running for cover. I don't want to discourage his love for music and also the fact that he loves to practice. I think that's important. And I keep biting my tongue to keep from telling him to practice in the garden or somewhere else outside of our house. Our house is cozy and we just don't have a basement, so we don't even have any room for a practice studio. I'm dreading trombone practice. Should I continue to fake enthusiasm or should I try and steer him towards a different instrument, like the flute?
Yeah, that the flute can be annoying.
Honestly, I don't know which one. I think the flute might be even more annoying.
Yeah, yeah. Well, he had this with Joe. Thank God Joe gave up on it.
He was a trumpet guy, right?
Yeah, and it was just, you know.
Bomb, bomb, bomb.
Yeah, hot cross buns.
Hot cross buns.
Hot cross buns, yeah.
See, I'm on the opposite side of this, of thinking that you're going to be terrible at an instrument for a long time before you get any better. So at that point, I don't know if he may get better at trombone, but it was the same as like me with guitar. I feel bad for my mom, thinking about for that first 2 years I played guitar, just trying to learn I was trying to learn Nirvana's Smells Like Teen Spirit, and I could not figure it out. And it was one of those, like, thinking back on how bad I was, I probably gave my mom so many headaches, and she is so.
Did you have it fully plugged in on an amp or?
Yes, both. Oh, okay. Acoustic and fully plugged in.
I was gonna say, if you just unplug a guitar and use headphones, I mean, at least you hear still the strings strumming, but it's not that obnoxious.
You say that. However, I mean, when it's I used to practice like 4 or 5 hours a day and, you know, switch between rooms. And like, I know that I gave myself a headache. Like, I can't even imagine my mom being like, man, this kid, he's never going to get better. However, I did. I finally learned the song and I got better.
It took 15 years, but you got it.
I mean, well, more like 25, but you know, it's fine.
Yeah, noise canceling headphones, or you put acoustic baffling up in the room that wherever this person's going to be, do whatever you can because it's hard to discourage them. But at the same time, who wants to go mad with bad instrument playing?
And I mean, guitar, yeah, that's awful. But I mean, trombone is like on another. But yeah, I think about it as a guy who grew up playing the drums. Not a very quiet, but when we were younger, maybe there were I don't even think there were electronic drums. And no. If there were, they were not cheap. So it's not like as if my parents. Yeah. But I know it drove my dad bonkers. Yeah. And to the point where it was like, you can't. And my dad was a studio drummer. He grew up as a session drummer for like some of these like great musicians back in the day. And then he got an arm injury and he couldn't play drums anymore. But like, he was a dude that loved the drums at one point. And you would think, hey, Apple, you know, doesn't fall too far from the tree, but he wanted that tree cut down. Like, he
did he think you were bad or just didn't want to hear it?
Yes.
Okay, well, you know what? I can appreciate it.
He didn't like that I didn't play a jazz style. Like, it bothered him to no end that I didn't hold it to traditional jazz grip. He would always try and tell me, because one stick kind of goes in it's almost like holding, like, instead of holding both, like,
these. Yes,
like,
yeah.
Like, right, like, you hold one almost like as if it's like a chopstick.
Yeah, exactly.
Like,
I remember that style. Yeah, you're right. It's chopstick style drumming. I remember that.
He would always brag about how I could do a drum roll with just one hand, blah, blah, blah. And, like, he would get so mad that I didn't want to play that style. But it got to the point where it's like the drumming stops when I'm home. Like, it was just, that was the way it was. And I've always, and it would make me feel bad for wanting to play the drums and all that stuff. And so now I'm thinking about that whenever the time comes that Tatum might want to play an instrument, and I'm going to be I know full well that I'm going to be like, hey, if you want to play a trumpet, I guess we're going to have you play the trumpet, you know, because I don't want to be that parent, because it sucked growing up having your parent make you feel bad for doing something that you love to do.
Yep. Get yourself some acoustic tiling.
I know.
Soundproof that room the best you can, because no parent wants to be mean, but that's an annoying sound over and over, especially if the kid is diligent. I mean, that makes it worse, where they keep practicing and keep practicing, and you're like, dude, you're not getting any better, and you're driving me nuts.
I wish they made an electronic trombone.
That'd be great. Yeah.
Any of those brass instruments, yeah, where it's like you get the same like feeling. Because I understand, like, there's certain ways you have to blow into that machine, that instrument.
Yep.
Otherwise, it doesn't make the sounds. So you would think, I mean, do they not? Where is the technology? Should we start this?
We should start this.
Apparently, there's such thing as a trombone mute that's supposed to, like, tone down the sound.
Oh, it's like a silencer for your trombone.
That's what it looks like.
That'll help
that sounds
a lot.
Like someone who, like, buries their face in a pillow so that you don't hear them making happy sounds. You still hear it.
Okay. I did not know we were going to get that glimpse into your life, but okay then.
You know what I mean? You're still
I know what you mean.
Yeah, I see it.
I know what you mean. I do remember there was a time people in your neighborhood were wild saying, hey, can you keep it down over there? So
I
understand that you have to muffle the happy noises. You've had to go through that in life.
We have discussed
that on this fine program.
Get him extra lessons and pay for that. That could be a good idea, especially if he has to go to a studio like where you actually get the lesson, so that way you're out of the house and you're getting better.
Yeah, but they do tell them to go practice at home.
Stop practicing.
And to BJ's point, and to your point, Steve, it's like back when I started playing guitar, noise-canceling headphones weren't a thing yet. Like, at that point, just invest in, like, either, like you said, soundproofing, or just get some noise-canceling headphones and just don't listen to your kid.
So I said dig a hole in the ground and throw them in there to practice.
There we go.
Yeah. I mean,
see, these are simple things. Everybody can dig a hole.
And get one of those cheap sheds at like Home Depot. And I don't think they're very cheap. They seem very expensive. And
that
just
is
make that the practice room.
Yeah, that is a great idea, though. Because that room, if you have space in your yard and all that, that can be a multi-purpose thing that is a well worth the investment, because it's outside the house. That's a great idea. And I think every parent, if you can and you have the room, should think about saving up for that now, because your kid's going to be, someone's going to be doing something that's going to irritate the hell out of you, and you're going to be like, oh, I wish I could throw you outside.
I don't know if this person knows this, but a couple people have been texting saying that there's a device that you can actually put in your trombone that will silence it, and then it links to headphones, so then only you can hear it.
Oh, is that better than what Vicky found?
If this person says it's a silent mute that goes into your headphone and you wear it. I had one in high school when I played the trumpet.
That's nice. Man, see, that would have saved.
They do have the technology.
Joey would have been a great trumpet player had we had that. Sorry, Joey.
That's okay.
Yeah. I don't think he would have been.
No.
He had his trumpet.
How's your bass playing going?
Oh, that's right. I forgot he started that.
It's moving. He has a girlfriend now, guys. He doesn't have time to practice.
He doesn't need to be a cool bassist to get girls anymore.
Joey. Yeah. Joey gave it up. Yeah, he's got the girl now.
He has no commitment to learning an instrument.
I feel like Joey's bass playing, Joey's trumpet playing, and Joey's basketball playing are all on par.
You know what? This is the motivation I needed.
Yeah.
I'm back.
Yeah. Are you?
Yeah. I'm back.
Yeah. I mean, you know, I'm wondering, like, when he was playing bass, Danny, did he ever complain about how the guitar wasn't working right the way he used to play on the basketball court, how all the other players...
He blames it on the strings.
The strings. It's not the right... I need a better clamp to hold on to, the strap.
I thought he was actually going to stick with this one, to be honest with
you. Yeah, no, I don't.
Have you learned a song yet?
Yeah.
No. Yeah.
Have I learned it well? No.
When's the last time you picked up your bass guitar, Joe?
I plead the fifth.
There we go. It's over.
Has it been more than a month?
Oh, definitely.
No, it's been less than a month.
Oh.
I mean, don't counting to move it to another spot in that
room. Yeah, it's been more than a month.
You know what? You always have to ask the witness the correct questions, Steve. Yeah. This is like growing up with Joe. I had to have so many questions because the way he would answer it would be correct, but it would not be the right answer I was looking for.
Yeah, he moved it so he could plug something in behind it. That doesn't count.
You're bringing back the memories of growing up with this kid in the house.
Someone said to the texter with the kid playing the trombone, please be patient with him. Practice makes perfect, and in time you'll be surprised at how good he gets. Don't shame him because he's not good sounding now.
Okay, yeah, you know, that's all well and good. You sit in the room next to a person playing badly for a long time. You know, we're not trying to shame anybody. It's just as it's driving parents crazy because the trombone's a sucky instrument, and when it's played badly, it's a multiple suck. It is. The trombone is trash. It'd be, you know, boom, boom, boom. I mean, I know it has its place.
I'm
but
sorry,
it's trash.
If I went to somebody's house and they had a trombone, I'm like, can you play that? And they said yes. I'm like, can you play it for me?
Yeah. Oh, I hate the trombone. I think it's
so. You don't like ska music.
That's true. Well, but it has its place. You know what I mean? Whereas when it's just trombone by itself and then trombone played badly, who wants to be around that? You know, it's like an elephant getting banged. Who needs to hear that?
What's worse, tuba or trombone?
Oh, yeah. You know what? Tuba's worse.
And that takes up a lot of space.
Yeah, it does.
I don't know if there's tuba silencers out there.
Yeah. Yeah, tuba's just a funny looking instrument, though. That's why
it does look kind of cool, though.
Yeah, yeah,
makes you want to march around
but
somewhere.
I really think the technology's out there. Silence that. Go get that, sir. Because if your kid becomes really good at it, that's awesome. You don't want to make the kid feel bad.
Well, also, I don't think you should really discuss, like that person even just said, the fact that he has the mindset that he wants to keep working at this. That's a good mindset to have. Like, hey, even though I'm not good at it right now, I'm going to keep putting in the work because that's gonna pay off. Forever. I mean, in anything that he does, like if you have that mindset of like, okay, I can't quit when things get difficult or things don't sound right. I have to keep putting in the time and the effort to be good at it. I don't think you want to discourage that.
But when you get home from work and you've had a harried, frenzied day and that just horrible noise is playing in your house, I mean, I feel badly for the parents. The kid's not doing anything wrong. It's just, it's unfortunately just the wrong
Can't the
place.
Parents like go on a walk or something like that and be like, hey, you know, we're gonna leave the house for the next hour. This is your time to work on the trombone.
An hour, huh?
And when we, I don't know. How long do you practice for trombone?
I mean, I would imagine if he's into it, multiple hours.
Yeah, that's the problem, Steve. All right. If he's really trying to be good.
You know what? Kick the kid out. Get him his own place.
Yeah.
That's not a bad. Maybe you can move in with the neighbors.
Yeah.
Oh, perfect idea.
You know what's funny is the entire.
Put him in the car and sit him outside and just close the windows.
Yeah, don't turn it on, though. That's important. I hear that's a bad thing.
Don't do that.
It's funny. The entire time we were talking about trombone, I was picturing a tuba. And now that I you said ska, and I was like, oh, the other brass instrument. Yes. Now it makes more sense to me.
I might think, and you know what? I also may have been confusing the trombone with the tuba
thing.
As well.
Yeah, the arm thing. Yeah, the long one.
Oh, that's not bad. Oh, that's actually a pretty deep. That's
you were thinking
horrible.
The big one, too.
I was thinking tuba.
So maybe he could come over to your house and practice at your house.
Yeah, I mean, the trombone actually, no, the trombone's not horrible. Okay, I take it back.
So tuba's worse?
Oh, tuba. That's what I thought this whole time, tuba. That's why I was like, that thing's a trash instrument. Trombone's cool.
So get an RV trailer. Then you can use it for vacation, and also that could be his practice space.
That's a good idea.
Oh, see, again, but an RV trailer as opposed to one of those little mini outside houses, I think the RV is going to be more expensive, isn't it?
Yeah, but it has more function.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, sure, you can drive the kid away. just put it in neutral and just send the kid on his way.
One text says, there's a silencer for every musical instrument. It's called a sledgehammer.
Oh, wow.
Oh, I get it. That's the animal house solution. You don't like it, just destroy it.
Drop them off at the in-laws' house, LOL.
Yeah, that is great. Grandma, grandpa will love to hear you practice, and I hate them, so here they go.
Well, they would at first. I think everything's adorable at first when, like, you know, like your grandkid is doing it until they keep doing it, and it sounds terrible.
I got news for you, Sarah. I will not find it adorable at first. Do not do that. I don't want the grandkid coming over practicing. Just so you know. Okay.
It is funny. Like we think about that now with Tatum. I mean, she's great. And she's not four yet. But it's like, what are her interests going to be? You know, you don't know. I don't want to force anything on her, obviously.
Trolling
is definitely number one. I mean, she does love ballet.
I was going to say, the fact that she hasn't stopped ballet yet is fantastic. We put Lily in softball when she was around 3 or 4, and she would just cry the entire time. Yeah. So it's like, clearly this kid doesn't like softball.
Didn't you tell her there's no crying in baseball? Gosh, she got it wrong right off the bat.
Did you bribe her with Chipotle after every game?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. So does she love ballet or does she love Chipotle? I mean, we really should take a look at this thing.
The answer is yes to both.
Okay, but that's interesting. Well, look, if she becomes a really good dancer, I mean, that's exciting.
You know what the funny thing is? That's when I'm starting to like get nervous. Like, I'm like, at some point, like, she's going to get good at this, and then it's going to be like the talented ballet class.
Oh, yeah, way more expensive.
Which,
not only that, way less fun.
Oh,
you know, I'm not a ballet guy. Like, you're dancing, you're spinning in circles. Cool. But when toddlers are doing it, it's hilarious because there's just like, it's almost lawless.
Yeah.
You know, props to the teachers. They try their best. But every once in a while,
one of the kids just keeps spinning around in a circle until it gets so dizzy it just falls over.
That's the best.
It's like watching kids play, toddlers play soccer.
Sure.
It's adorable, but then all of a sudden when they start getting a bit more competitive, then it's kind of like, okay.
Well, if you're lucky.
It's probably more fun for you, but not as much fun for dad now.
You should talk to Sarah, and she'll tell you to find a dance teacher that doesn't just teach ballet. So at least when you go to these recitals, they're entertaining, because ballet sucks. It does. Nutcracker my ass. I don't want to see any of that. But Sarah,
I don't want to kink shame you, but okay.
Yeah. But, you know, I mean, but when I saw it, but Sarah did all sorts of dance. Like, it wasn't just ballet. It was all sorts of stuff. So you got to see some really cool performances that were a lot more modern, where ballet is just, I know, people go, it's trash.
I know. I kind of want to push her to get, I want the hip hop dance. Oh, yeah. See that.
Yeah, exactly. That, and that's what, I mean, Sarah excelled at that, but there's modern dance, jazz dance, you know, even like you could do whatever was
Tap dance?
Tap dance, yeah. All sorts of cool different kinds of dance. Ballet, I know I say it's trash. I understand it's amazing and elegant and beautiful. It just doesn't work for me.
I'll double down on it. It sucks.
Yeah. It just doesn't work for me.
Are they going to do a version of the Nutcracker this year, Steve?
Oh, God, don't.
I don't know.
No. Steve will be snoring, and his wife or everybody around him. Dude, you can't survive the Nutcracker.
I can survive if my daughter's in it.
Dude. Even if your daughter's in it, the Nutcracker is so life-sucking.
Okay, as long as it's a shortened version of it.
Oh, man, it is. In order to stay away, I literally need somebody to crack my in the Nutcracker just because it's so boring. Mm. I went to, and I know it was a beautiful performance at the Seattle Rep or whatever, and God dang, I could not stay awake. I was like you at every movie. It's just like, God, who cares about these? It's so,
Someone says, you guys are being a-holes. My kids learned and played well today. They play piano, percussion instrument, sax, guitar, vocals. Parents need to be better. Shame on them.
Wait.
I've been saying, like, let the kid keep doing it.
Yeah, and why are we a-holes when I just
take a hole and put them in the hole
and
then put a tarp over it? No.
Yeah, I mean, look, look, being supportive of your kids is great, but also being supportive of somebody who comes home from a hard day at work and they just, you know, that horrible sound is going to drive them nutty. I mean, that's a thing, too. You got to find a happy medium. Yeah, Jake, don't shame the kid, that's for sure. We're not saying that.
Says, I have my son plays the saxophone. He sucked at first, but now he's pretty good. Nice.
Well, that's because he didn't talk back. Mm. Yakety sax. Don't talk back.
Wait, yakety sax?
Yeah.
You know. I thought it was yakety sack.
I thought it was yakety sax because you play it on the sax. It's not yakety sax?
I don't know, but sax doesn't rhyme with back. Sack does.
Listen, if you're rhyming sack with back,
yeah.
Is it sax?
It is. Yeah, it's sax. S-A-X.
Well, I was today years old when I realized the actual lyrics to the song.
I think, you know what? You're clicking on a different thumbnail if you're getting yakety sack.
I thought I got hacky sackers. I don't know.
By the way, yakety sack would be a great name for somebody.
So they're talking about the saxophone?
Oh, it's a saxophone song. But, I mean, that's why it's called yakety sax.
I don't even know how it sounds other than yakety sax, don't talk back.
Yeah, that's about it.
But now it's yakety sax, don't talk back.
Yeah, all I have is the Benny Hill theme in my head with the saxophone, but I don't think that's the song. That's not yakety sax, right?
I don't think so.
No. Ah, man. Look at Vicky and Danny. They don't even know who Benny Hill is.
I do, too.
You do? Your father, he taught you right?
He probably was on Family Guy.
It was probably on a cartoon. It's always on cartoons.
Oh, Benny Hill, such an inappropriate show. It was an inappropriate show, but it was funny. There was a woman that was actually catfished by a guy claiming to be a pop music icon. And this woman scammed out of thousands of dollars. I'll tell you all about this at 7:47 on The Rock.
Today's podcast was brought to you by Travis Gagne, bankruptcy attorney. He's here right now and has agreed to answer more of your questions about bankruptcy. Travis, if you're upside down in your mortgage, should you continue to make the payment?
Continuing to pay your mortgage or not is a complex decision because you're going to have to pay to live somewhere. You're going to have a housing payment. So continuing to make your house payment really depends on several factors. One is whether or not you have a second mortgage. The second one is how affordable your ongoing monthly mortgage payment is.
Another issue is whether your mortgage is adjustable and you're facing an increase in your mortgage payments later on when interest rates go up. If you do have a second mortgage in this economy with the housing prices being down, oftentimes we can take off or strip off that second mortgage in a Chapter 13 case so that you'd only have the first mortgage to continue to pay.
Thanks, Travis. If you have more questions about bankruptcy, you can reach out to Travis anytime at ChooseTheRightChapter.com. That's ChooseTheRightChapter.com. And thanks for listening.
We all know cats are intelligent. Felix Cat Insurance was able to secretly record two cats on a hidden microphone. Let's listen in.
Did you hear the one about the three dogs at the park?
That's old, like four lives ago. But did you hear about the new pet insurance just for cats from FelixCatInsurance.com?
Of course. What do I look like, a dog?
When you're coughing up a furball. Yes. Listen, Felix Cat Insurance plans start at under $1 per day and are as unique as you and me. They call it whisker-to-tail protection.
Even furballs?
Even that. Remember the last time you had a furball? I made a TikTok. It went viral.
Oh, that's good. Wait, you're on social media?
There you have it. Felix Cat Insurance. Customizable coverage exclusively for felines. Sorry, no dogs allowed. FelixCatInsurance.com. Get it? Meow. Insurance is underwritten by Independence American Insurance Company and produced by Independence Pet Group. Pre-existing conditions are not covered. For all terms and limitations, visit FelixCatInsurance.com/terms.
From the very beginning, your kids mean everything to you. That means you do anything for them, especially if they're at risk. So when it comes to type 1 diabetes, screen it like you mean it. Because even if just one person in the family has it, your child is up to 15 times more likely to get it, too. Screen it like you mean it. Because type 1 diabetes can develop at any age. And once you get results, you can get prepared for your child's future. So screen it like you mean it. Type 1 starts long before there are symptoms. But one blood test could help you spot it early, before they need insulin, and could lower the risk of serious complications like diabetic ketoacidosis or DKA. Talk to your doctor about how to screen for type 1 diabetes, because the more you know, the more you can do. So don't wait. Tap now or visit screenfortype1.com to learn more. Again, that's screenfortype1.com. Screen it like you mean it.
Some companies are big, others are small. To Robert Half, their hiring needs are equally huge. At Robert Half, our specialized recruiting professionals elevate their expertise with proprietary AI tools to transform candidate discovery, assessment, and selection. Whether sourcing talent locally or in any geography that works for you, Robert Half can pinpoint hard-to-find candidates in finance and accounting, technology, marketing and creative, legal, and administrative and customer support. At Robert Half, we know talent.
Transit is better with an Orca card. Here's why. One, it's easy. Just tap and pay your way onto Metro and all other public transit around the Sound. Two, your tap shows us when and where you're riding the most, so Metro can serve you better. And three, Orca cards are for everyone. 18 and younger now ride free with a free youth Orca card. So what are you waiting for? Get an Orca card. Tap for transit and make your ride count today. Visit kingcounty.gov/tap for transit.
Have you or a loved one been injured in an accident? Are you struggling to recover fair compensation? Look no further. At Phillips Law Firm, the experienced personal injury attorneys will fight for your rights and get you the justice and compensation you deserve. They handle a wide range of cases, including car accidents, slip and falls, medical malpractice, and workplace injuries. Justice is a phone call away, so don't wait. Call today for a free case review. Call 1-800-JUSTICE or visit justiceforyou.com.
Looking to give the gift of pleasure? Add a little high heat to keep the desire burning. Or maybe you just need a little self-care. Come to Lovers for the best lingerie and toys to keep things hot this holiday. Save 20% on your purchase with Lovers Afterglow Rewards. Just mention LOVE20 at one of our 18 Western Washington locations. Offer valid with free Lovers Afterglow Rewards membership until November 30th. Some exclusions apply.
Your driver's license is important so you can get back and forth to work, get your kids to school, and back and forth to daycare. If your license has been suspended because you can't pay your tickets, you can't do any of those things. Let's talk about Chapter 13 bankruptcy. You may have heard the tickets cannot be discharged, but they can be dealt with in a Chapter 13 case. Why not come in for a free consultation? The chapter you choose will make all the difference to your getting back, legally, on the road. Let's design a plan to pay off your tickets and restore your license immediately. I'm attorney Travis Gagné. Please contact me today at ChooseTheRightChapter.com. That's ChooseTheRightChapter.com.
99.9 KISW, the Rock of Seattle. I don't know, man. I don't know if it's just because it's an old person or it just seems like it's always like people just fooled by celebrities getting catfished. This woman scammed out of thousands of dollars from her retirement fund by a man pretending to be Barry Gibb of the Bee Gees.
Barry Gibb?
Yeah.
Oh, man, I love it. Aiming high.
Yeah, her name is Wanda, and she thought she was in an online relationship with Barry Gibb for some time. And she claims that she went on one of Gibb's web pages one day and clicked on a button that gave her the option to message him. And they began exchanging messages, and Wanda admitted she didn't believe it was him at first, because it's not.
Well,
gosh, why does somebody, like, in your right mind, why would you think? I think it's good that I'm me. I have such low self-esteem that I would never get catfished, but like, because there's no way any celebrity would spend any time with me.
Yeah, I mean, typically, if it's too good to be true, that's because it's not true.
Yeah. And this individual acting as Gibb.
In all fairness, she went on a website that she thought was probably like the legit website for the Bee Gees. And would you ever think that like you would get screwed over because you went to a website?
Yeah, I get it. My point being is that why would you think that you, grandma, it's a website that anybody has access to. Why did you think you were so special? Barry Gibb's like, you're my lady.
And also, though, on the flip side, somebody created a fake Bee Gees website, apparently, in order for...
Yes.
Hoping that someone would eventually reach out to them? That seems like a very strange long-term power play. Like, okay, we're going to create this website. At some point, some lady's going to reach out to us and find our website and want to talk to Barry Gibb, and that's when the scam starts.
Yep.
That's kind of crazy.
Yeah, oh my gosh. And of course, he was like in a video, so he declined a request for a video chat and said that he'd been blackmailed by a fan once after speaking with them through video. That's why he won't do it. And she's like, oh, that's understandable.
I mean, kind of is.
Kidding. Then their chat started getting really intimate, according to Wanda. Ooh. And she shared that she had never been charmed by someone that way before and that his messages started to get more sexual over time. And it's like, okay, Wanda. She was aware that Gibb was married, but said that the Gibb impersonator told her he was looking to leave his wife for her. Really?
See, all this seems very understandable.
Yeah. And he then
there are no red flags that this lady has seen yet.
And here's what he said. Start looking for a house for them to move into together in Oregon, because Barry Gibb, of course, you know, let's leave England and go to Oregon together.
Massive Goonies fan. He wants to live in Astoria.
That's what it is.
Yeah.
So she sent $11,000 from her retirement fund to pay for the house that she thought she was going to live in with Barry Gibb.
And so does she have any family? Do you think anybody said, hey, Wanda, are you sure you want to send this kind of money?
She must not have. People must not have been checking up on her. Or was she embarrassed and never said this was going on to her family? That's the other thing. Is like, hey, how is it going, Grandma? Oh, good. Anything new in your life? Nope, not at all.
Met a nice man. We've been talking.
She sent him 20 grand in addition to the 11 grand. She sent him 20 grand to help him get through his divorce.
Well, yeah, I mean, if you want to, you can't be with a married man.
Well, the show Catfish was able to prove to her that her money wasn't going to the actual Barry Gibb. And also a post on Gibb's verified Facebook page, which was written by the musician's son, Steven, warned that there had been other accounts impersonating his father. And we've seen that. I mean, the people go out there and impersonate everybody. We had that issue for a long time. So, God,
Dude, but you know what the crazy thing is? Like, okay. She clearly needed to do a little bit better. Like, listen to her gut and also maybe, like, you know, the fact that he doesn't want to talk on video. But we're so close with artificial intelligence. Like, we could already mimic people's voices. Like, catfishing is going to get to a whole other level. Eventually, they're also going to be able to mimic probably video.
Yeah.
You know, with the deep fakes that we've seen before.
You're right.
Could you imagine at some point, like, you know, we got the stupid Memoji thing on our phone Tatum loves so she could be a unicorn. And, like, you know, when she talks, the thing's mouth moves. I mean, how far are we from technology that you could just be like, insert celebrity here, and then you can FaceTime someone and pretend to be Barry Gibb from the Bee Gees?
That's going
to
be a scary thing.
That's what I mean.
It's going to be a very, very scary thing.
As I'm listening to the story, I'm like, okay, she's not very bright, but at some point, this AI technology is going to be used for bad.
Oh, yeah. I think
rather quickly.
I feel badly for her because of the amount of money spent. Because usually dudes, you know, I don't know. I mean, dudes do get catfished. I don't know how much money they give up, but usually dudes give up money to, you know, porn stars or, you know, like OnlyFans, chat rooms, something like that. But they know what they're getting into. They're getting a value for the amount of money they're spending. This poor woman, unfortunately, did not get value for the money she spent. But
there are also some people out there that are putting money into some of these OnlyFans or going to like certain strip clubs thinking that the attention that they're getting is more than just a financial agreement.
Yeah, well, that they're crazy people.
Yeah.
They are crazy people if they think that person is going to be like Julia Roberts and they're going to pretty woman them. But I don't know how much they're spending either. But at least, you know, I mean, it's all like, you know, you're paying for someone to dance, you're paying for whatever. Unless, like you said, Steve, maybe there's even more that goes on with it, you know, like the private dance. If you just give me $10,000, I'll be yours forever.
I think you found like the pictures of like Barry Gibb sent her with a little love note attached to the picture.
It looks so bad.
So photoshopped.
She says that, like, he sent her a message like, I just got hit by a car, baby, and sends a picture of him in the hospital with a broken leg, but it looks so fake. And then there's one where he's holding up a sign that is clearly someone just writing over it, maybe even on paint.
Best part is you look at this and it's meant to look like it's a handwritten note from Barry Gibb, but they're just using the font that makes it look like it's handwritten because all the letters look exactly the same.
Oh my gosh.
She just wanted to believe this so bad that she wasn't willing to pay attention.
Loneliness is a big thing for a lot of old people.
But then you wonder if maybe the family member is just like, Aunt Wanda's just dumb. Like, just let her do it. She just needs to learn a lesson. Like, we've told her so many times that this is not... Look at this picture. If she doesn't want to listen to us and wants to believe this, let this be a valuable lesson to Aunt Wanda.
Yeah. I mean, it's just so frustrating because it's also... He's a celebrity. Had this been some rando? I mean, if that's the other thing, is that what... I think the celebrityness of him made her feel special. Barry Gibb loves me as opposed to Schlemke Rice loves me. Would she have given $20,000 to a dude that was as charming but had no celebrity? I don't think so.
He had as nice hair as Barry Gibb does.
Well, Barry Gibb still got some good looking flow.
What if it was really Barry Gibb and he's like, you know, no one ever believes me. I'm just trying to find love. I'm not happy in my marriage and I found this nice lady.
I want to go to Oregon. Don't people believe me? I want to go to Oregon. Yeah, this is $31,000 she spent out of her retirement fund. And I don't think she's getting that back. Wow, that's unfortunate.
Yeah, I wonder, have they been able to track down the people that have been catfishing her?
Yeah, that would be great. The catfish just proved that it wasn't him. I don't know if they found the originals, though.
Right.
Like, who the people behind that website. Oh, oh, man. I kids, make sure you keep track of me, okay?
If dad starts thinking like, you know, I don't know, what would be the celebrity that you would want to be catfished by?
Cindy Lauper.
Yeah. Cindy Lauper.
Cindy Lauper would be, I would believe it.
And if all of a sudden you go, Joe, I'm going to send $5,000 to Cindy Lauper.
She said she wants to have fun. She's just a girl that wants to have fun. And hey, she said she wants to have fun with me.
Joe, please don't stop him. Let him do it.
Yeah, I'll let him do it. I'm the one who's got the account.
That'd be great if your son is the one catfishing you.
That is all
he's pocketing the money for his gambling habit.
For his trips to North Carolina across the country. No more gambling.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's not so bad. At least it's staying in the family. Like, I'm giving money to somebody in the family at least.
So your son's scamming you for money.
Yeah.
Making you think that you're in love with Cindy Lauper when really you're just communicating with him.
Well, if he's that good, make me think that he's Cindy Lauper, he deserves the money.
And he has his girlfriend call you and does a Cindy Lauper impression.
Oh, see? Yeah.
This is getting weird.
It's a good plan.
I want this all to happen.
All right.
It can.
Yeah.
But give it a week. PJ will forget we even talked about this.
You're right.
Yeah.
You're absolutely right. This can work.
This can work.
This can work. Let's go.
It's either that or William Shatner. One of the two.
Oh, I don't know if I give money to Shat. I love Shat, but I mean, look, it's got. I'm giving money for romance. Okay,
that's it. And then Joe has to impersonate William Shatner and be like, "BJ, give me money now,
yeah. Right now.
Let's go to space."
Is that William Shatner as a wrestler?
Yes.
Okay,
brother.
Yeah.
Beat me up some money.
Yeah. I. Oh man. Are you hoping that you know? Like, look, I'm in my 60s. And still have my faculties. I don't want to make fun of this woman too much because that could be me someday. I could just think that it's real, like you said, Steve, with deep fake and all this stuff and AI. We think she's a dope, but man, will that be me someday?
So BJ's, they have an older demographic. It sounds like they were targeting seniors. What a tragedy.
Tragedy!
That's a song.
Oh, okay.
Come on, you guys, you got to get with the Bee Gees stuff.
Yeah, I totally don't know the Bee Gees very well. I got it. Nice.
That's why I didn't say. I was like, I can't believe she could have figured out if it was really him if she just could tell by the way he walks.
Oh, there we go. You know, you started a joke and it didn't go so well.
No. Yeah. But I'm staying alive, man. I'm doing all right. Okay. Someone said this happened to my dad with some person pretending to be a 36-year-old woman, and he sent her, I don't even know how much. I had to find the original pictures to prove it.
Oh, no. So he got scared. You know, it's... Ah, if people are paying it, you know, when a beautiful woman is talking to you, you really have to ask why, you know, especially somebody who's multiple years younger than you. Mm-hmm. You gotta know who you are and look in the mirror and go, yeah, I, you know what? No one's going to play for me like that. You know, no, it's just not going to happen.
But there are some really like, I think just gullible people when it comes to love and romance.
Yeah. Anytime a young woman approaches me, I'm going, she's a hoe. You know, it's just what it is.
Which is weird because we've had to have multiple times. Like, no, that's just a salesperson that just got hired on.
Yeah.
You need to stop doing this, BJ.
Sorry about that.
HR is getting a little annoyed with your actions.
Anytime somebody comes up to me, I go, hey, ho. It's just all those times in Vegas because that's like, hey, buddy. I'm like, no, listen, I know you're a ho. Get away from me.
But I remember even having like a buddy that came up from college. And this is back in the MySpace days, and we're having lunch, and it's a fun little conversation. I haven't seen him in years, and then I'm like, well, how have things been? He's like, a lot better since I got my hair implants. And I'm just like, what does that even mean? I was like, are you trying to, like, what do you mean? He goes, well, ever since I got my hair implants, man, I can't stop getting messages from ladies. Hmm. And he shows me, like, his MySpace messages.
Oh, boy.
And they're those bots. Remember back in the day?
Yeah.
I mean, I'm sure this still happened with, like, Facebook as much, but I remember there was a moment in MySpace, a time where it felt like every porn bot was like reaching a hi, handsome, hello, sexy, and he's showing me this.
And he doesn't get that it's like totally just vague.
And I'm just like, dude, those are like fake. Those are like,
it's not your hair, buddy.
They're bots. There's nothing. And I remember him looking, he goes, you don't need to be jealous, man. And I'm like, you're right. My bad. As a bald man, I see you. I'm just like looking at him like,
you don't
man.
Need to be jealous. All these bots are after me.
Was I just really wasted throughout college, or were you this stupid all the time? And I didn't even realize it.
Yeah, I think you know your answer.
I couldn't believe that.
Wow.
He was convinced that because of his hair implants, that all of a sudden hot girls wanted him on MySpace.
You know, if I didn't have arguments with bots all the time, I would make fun of that guy.
That is a good point. You don't want to find romance. You just want to have a spirited debate.
Yeah, I will fight with people, and it's usually just bots and trolls.
And they'll finally give, like, look, dude, I'm just a robot trying to scam people out of money. I'm tapping out.
Yeah, exactly. That's what I hope. Why would a guy fake having a heart attack more than 20 times? Well, I'll tell you why at 8:17 on The Rock.
BJ and Migs, mornings on The Rock, 99.9 KISW.
This holiday season, make your journey memorable with Travel Centers of America. Visit our one-stop shop for all your holiday travel needs. Fuel up, get snacks, and dine at one of our full-service restaurants. Hit the road with peace of mind knowing we've got you covered. Travel Centers of America.
99.9 KISW, The Rock of Seattle. Okay, this guy's a legend. He's a 50-year-old guy in Spain. He's being accused of faking a heart attack just to get out of paying a restaurant bill. And apparently, he's done this at least 20 times.
Oh, my. Wow. You would think that's just bad karma. Because one day he's going to have a heart attack. And people are like, dude, you're not getting those nachos for free.
Yeah, he was at one restaurant where he ordered several glasses of white label whiskey to wash down a Russian salad before faking the heart attack. And multiple restaurants have been passing his photo around to warn other places. Since then, he has been caught and was sentenced to 42 days in jail. And there could be more trouble for him. They were considered minor crimes, these scams, because the totals weren't a lot individually. But the restaurant owners are planning to file a joint complaint, which could lock him up for 2 years for doing this.
Imagine that's the reason why you're behind bars. Like, you're there, and like, what are you in for? Why is it pretend to have heart attacks so I can get free food?
I mean, it is. Look, it's a scammy thing to do, and it's, what a douche. But, you know, you think about other people that get off, like the stuff that they do, and they're getting let out of jail, and people go, how's that person on the streets again? And then this guy might be behind bars.
Someone said, I was once that guy that used to try and get free food by putting my own hair in the food, and it worked most of the time.
Oh, man.
That's a whole other, man, just hearing from how you got, did you ever do anything to scam free meals?
You know, I never did.
Oh, you're a man of integrity.
Yeah, of course, I don't have any hair, so that's a problem. I think I probably would have tried that if I had some.
Borrow some from the bathroom sink right now.
Because
apparently somebody decided to like shave their head in our sink.
No. What?
Did you not see the random hairs that were in the sink?
I haven't been in the bathroom today.
Oh, yeah.
Wow. At least not when I saw that. That's disgusting.
I know it's not, nothing, but it's like, it might be beard hair.
Oh, weird.
I hope it is, because sometimes I think it's...
It's not pubic hair.
You sure?
Positive, it's straight.
Oh, okay. Oh, that's just, why would you do that at work? Who's doing that at work?
I don't know. I have my suspicions.
I actually do as well.
Yeah.
Because we do actually have, yeah.
I've seen people do weird things in the bathrooms, though, so it doesn't surprise me at all.
But you got to wash. Like, you got to wash that out of the sink and wash it down the drain.
Yeah, wouldn't you leave making sure it was a lot of hair. It wasn't like filled the entire sink, but it was obvious that somebody shaved in our bathroom right now.
Huh. How are you that clueless? Because it's a white sink. How can you not see the black hair or the brown hair that's on there?
And I'm talking shaved with, like, must have been like hair clippers.
Oh, wow. Oh, damn.
Because each hair was about an inch-ish long.
Wow. Oh, well, in that case, I'm not sure who that might be.
Yeah, it wasn't something we use like a razor and you put it on the sink and like little stubble comes out.
Write down who you think it is. Go ahead.
Yeah, I'll write down who I think it is.
Yeah, you got a thing?
I got a thing. Oh, yeah, I got a thing.
Okay, I want to see. I thought it was this one person, but I thought so, too, but I don't. Does that person have that much hair?
That's what I was thinking.
I was thinking that, too, but do they have enough hair to do it?
I don't know.
On the sides? Maybe they give them just a little bit. I don't know if it's a beard hair. I don't know.
Yeah, that's not cool.
Somebody here did it.
That's so funny.
Or it's a cleaning.
Could it be?
That's what I was thinking. I thought it could be that person, and we're unfortunately picking the wrong guy.
No, I don't think so.
But that person might have enough hair to do that.
Yeah, that's fair, but I know how he's
I know
very...
it's not me.
Okay, how about this?
Really, Steve, I thought it was you.
Armpit hair. I cut my armpit hair, guys.
Steve, I think for the business of radio...
Yes.
We could, the second person we could call out, and they would come in and admit or not admit. What do you think? I think as they...
I think he would.
All right. So, okay. Veggie dog.
Listening right now.
Veggie dog. It's going to take a little while with the delay. But Veggie dog, would you please come in here and confirm or deny that you are the kitchen, the bathroom trimmer?
All right, yeah, so I don't think, I mean, unless someone cleaned it out of the sink since then, but when I went in the bathroom and I went to wash my hands, I'm like, why is there a bunch of, I went and used the other sink.
Because Veggie dog has a lot of hair.
Yes.
Here he comes. I mean, he's got a beard. Look at him.
No, it's definitely not his beard hair. Hair is a little too curly.
Look how angry he is.
Yeah. No, I'm not angry. I'm always serious, but I knew that my name would come up because I have a lot of hair.
Yeah.
But I am wearing...
Looking at you right now, I'm positive that it wasn't Jason.
So you're saying no, Veggie Dog is... You can tell by forensic evidence that it's not even Veggie Dog.
So that removes that suspect.
He looks pissed. Damn. Veggie Dog looks pissed.
My guess is that this guy...
I think that's a possibility, and I thought that might be who it is, but at the same time, he just got back in this morning.
Okay, well, that's kind of narrowing it down now.
No one outside the studio knows who we're talking about.
That's the point, is the people inside the studio know who's talking about it. I want to try to stay out of all that kind of trouble.
Somebody said some people have straight pubic hair.
Oh, wow.
Back to Jason.
Jason, you've been known for that.
Here's what I will tell you about my region.
Okay, jeez.
It is coiffed.
I don't need to know that.
Oh, my God. Do we need to know that? Well, is it quaff because you just did it in the bathroom? Is that why it's quaff?
I do.
That does not let you off the hook.
All of my grooming habits happen in the sanctuary and the privacy of my own abode.
I figured he was too straight-laced to do anything at work.
Dude, isn't it weird to think, though, Jason is, like, quaffed in that area, but he looks like he's ready to go into the forest with the, like, he's got the total into the forest, go off the grid look up top, but on the bottom, he's ready for smoothness.
Well, he's a human mullet.
Exactly. Yeah, he is. Right. He's definitely a human mullet.
Joe, can you run into the bathroom and take a picture of the sink and see if it's still there? And if so, that way at least these guys can see what I'm talking about.
Yeah, Joe, that's a great idea.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah. It's the sink to the left. It should still be, unless someone cleaned it out, but it was just there. And I'm like, you can wet a piece of paper and like scoop it up if it doesn't go down the drain.
Sure.
It just seems odd that someone would cut their hair and then just leave a mess.
How long is the hair, though?
I'd say about an inch
long. Look at Jason. Huh. You know, Veggie Dog.
Straight hair.
You're doing a great job as somebody trying to throw us off the track.
You're welcome.
Yeah. You know, but maybe it is you, Mr.
Quaff.
You
think he's in cahoots? Maybe he's the guy cutting people's hair.
Oh, he's cutting people. Well, there he is.
Well, and plus, I like to do it the old-fashioned way with a pair of long scissors, too. So I don't use anything electric.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. The long scissors are where you got to
go. Yeah, absolutely. Because then you really get up in there or down.
Give one of those old timey barbershop things where you get the blade and just do it that way.
Oh, a straight razor?
In the old West.
Man. Yeah, that's where it's at.
That's the, you know, get the big foam on there and just basically.
Oh, no. Dry.
Do that Bat Masterson look. Here we go. Oh, dry. Oh, that's how they do it in the old West before they had the big foam.
How long does it take your son to get to the bathroom and back? Is he like doing somersaults to get there? Like, I mean,
have you ever seen him walk? He's a very casual walker.
Is he crawling?
This is how he used to play basketball. He would just casually go up and down the court and complain about how bad the team was.
Is there zero sense of urgency?
It's not there anymore. Somebody heard us. Oh.
Interesting.
Wow.
Yeah, it would have been that one right there.
It's gone. Steve, were you imagining things? Are you doing mushrooms?
Maybe.
Yeah. I mean,
were you in the wrong bathroom?
I got news for you.
I mean, those cupcakes maybe were laced with something.
What, you mean it was the women's bathroom? All right. Oh. All right. Now, who's the subject now?
Is
Vicky the only one here?
Damn it. I knew I should have taken a picture of it because I was like, no one's going to believe me.
Because I was in there.
I never saw it.
I never saw it either. I was in there one time today.
So what, I just imagined a bunch of hair?
I'm not saying you imagined it.
To Steve's point, occasionally Ryan Castle will leave one of his long beard hairs draped over the urinal or in the sink.
I don't think that's a beard hair. I don't think that's a beard hair.
There are always stray hairs, and it's very disturbing in that bathroom.
But this was an abundance of stray hairs. It wasn't like as if like a couple hairs fell off a guy's head.
Right.
Like, it was, it was there.
Maybe somebody called in a mobile barber.
Somebody's tripping.
Yeah, all are for thinking that I just magically saw hair that disappeared. They probably went back in there and cleaned it.
Flashbacks are a thing, man. All those shrooms you did back in your day.
Somebody said, hey, maybe they had to trim it up and get back on the air, but cleaned it at the next break.
Oh.
That is very possible.
Well, that if that's true, then we do narrow it down to somebody who's in the building that's on the air.
We are in the time window where the building maintenance crew does come through and clean up and wipe down the bathroom.
What a sucky job for that guy. I always see that poor guy, and I say hi to him, and I'm like,
I feel bad too because I call him Tidy Bowl Guy because he always smells like bathroom cleaner.
Do you call him Tidy Bowl Guy to his face?
Of course not.
Oh, no, he calls him TB Guy.
Of course not. I'm like, hey, we've got a great report.
Hey, man.
Maybe it was
man,
him.
His name,
hey,
I don't know.
You?
Hey, TB Guy.
Maybe it was him.
That guy, you think that guy, he cleans the place, then he trims his pubes and leaves him in the sink?
He's probably here overnight.
All right, thank you, Veggie Dog.
Thank you.
I still think Veggie Dog's prime suspect.
No, that's fair.
I bet he is. I bet he heard us talking about it, quickly cleaned it, and then came in.
Yeah, exactly. And then he had to tell us how he's like, oh, I'm smooth. I don't even have anything down there.
I just think it's a strange thing to cut your hair in a workplace sink.
Oh, dude, I know sometimes people have to brush their teeth and everything, but I always think it's weird when people brush their teeth at work. I was just like, have a piece of gum or just use some breath mint.
I saw a dude at the gym that was full on just grooming his entire body.
Oh, that's not good to see.
And I'm just like, what are we doing now?
Let's
do it in the shower. They have a shower. You have a battery powered trimmer.
Yeah, you kind of want to do it in there. I mean, I don't need to see you, Sammy Swiffer, grooming your stuff as you're basically hitting the floor.
Sammy Swiffer.
Oh, that's what I call the old guys that like to just do that pose, the Captain Morgan pose, when they talk to you.
Oh,
and you're just like, okay, Grandpa. Honestly, I don't need to see that. Yeah, man.
Yeah, you do.
I really don't. Oh, man, it's like truck nuts. I just don't. You know, as you walk away,
gym nuts.
Yeah, I don't need to see that. Oh. Hey, there's an anonymous fan who was at Wednesday's Philadelphia Phillies game who bought two rounds of beer for section 103. Not one, but two rounds.
Wow. Now, that's entire section?
352 seats. And the drinks cost between $12 and $16, which means that fan probably spent close to $10,000, like $9,000, they're saying.
I'd have been so stoked.
Man, I was fired up when we won, like, those chicken nuggets at the cracking game.
Yeah.
Now, look.
Two beers?
The Phillies had a great series, and people are really excited about the fact that they have this incredible home field advantage. Do you think he was just trashed? And, boy, when he got home, he's like, what the hell did I just do?
I heard a couple of the clips, like, people were, like, freaking out. But one person, I think, even said, like, oh, no, I know who did it. He doesn't want to be known, but I know who did it, and he's just a good guy.
Okay.
Wow. It's probably just a rich good guy.
That's nice, because, yeah. You know, I could see me. I mean, you know me. I mean, thank God at the ATM had a limit when I was at the strip joint and drunk.
Yes.
I could see me being very excited for my team. I had a round of drinks for everybody.
Now he could have been drunk. But it sounds like as if like he's just a good guy and maybe he just wanted to like hook everybody up.
That's awesome.
But the Phillies do really good that night or something?
Oh, yeah. The Phillies, they kicked ass.
So, okay. I was just like, yeah. Or was he just like so sad? He's just like, so sorry, guys.
Round the drinks for everybody.
Yeah.
Yeah, the Phillies are at least a story that people are talking about because of their incredible home field advantage. Right. And they're thinking that, you know, now that they're playing the Braves, who are a really, really good team, we'll see what happens, baby. We'll see what happens.
If I spent like nearly $10,000, you bet your ass I'm going to let everybody know I was the reason why it happened.
Oh, yeah.
You know what? Even though you're telling us that, I think we know that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But yeah, Jared, drinks were on me. Go Phillies.
Yeah, you're up there doing it.
High-fiving everybody. Because that's like a fun moment to be able to say, hey, I just bought everybody around the drink, especially stadium price drinks.
Let's be honest. You're going to make sure Gritty is there with you, even though that's not his sport. But the fanatic, you're going to let him all know.
I'll take the Philly fanatic.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, that bitch better get over here and high-five me.
I mean, now look, $9,000 for drinks. Yeah, I think the Philly fanatic can high-five you for that.
I feel like somebody would be able to get a hold of the Philly fanatic to come over and high-five me if I just bought an entire section.
Yeah.
Two rounds of drinks.
Yeah, man, that's fantastic.
The video is great, though. The beer vendor guy's like, hey, these are all free. Just show me your ID. And everyone's like, let's go, Phillies.
Yeah.
I wonder if he got a good tip from that.
Dude, I wonder.
He had to have. If you're buying $9,000 worth of drinks, you got to give the guy a nice tip.
No, but if you're one of the people getting the free drink, because he's still lugging all those drinks to you.
Oh, you got to give him a buck at least, don't you?
I feel like hopefully enough people maybe floated him a $5 here, $10 there that it evened
out. That's a lot of good dough for him. If you get 5 or 10.
Not from everybody, but because, dude, there's going to be a bunch of cheap asses that aren't going to even give a dollar.
Well, 352 people, let's just say on average the guy gets $5. Which is still half price for a drink. I mean, so that's nice. That's good money.
I think he's going to get $5 a person on average.
Mm-mm. Oh, that's
I think he might get $1 a person on average. I think he might walk away with about $300 in tips.
Oh, that's unfortunate. I think he should get at least $600. I'd give him at least a deuce. You got to give him a two spot.
You give him a deuce? Okay.
Well, I mean, their drinks cost like $12 to $15.
No. I'm not.
Yeah.
I'm not arguing. I would definitely throw him if I had a $5 bill in my pocket, or I'd be like, yo, what's your Venmo?
You know what? Nowadays, it's probably a good idea to have a Venmo you can give people. You're right.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a good way to get tips. Yesterday, Steve, he did get this one wrong.
Which form of energy can we see with the naked eye?
My tushy.
What?
Which form of energy can we see with the naked eye?
You know, that's...
No.
Lightning.
No.
Clouds.
No. Okay.
After that last segment and you seeing mysterious hairs in the sink, you're high, my friend. You're having a flashback.
I don't even know what the context was there.
Oh, the context was is you're high. You're having a flashback.
I go to the bathroom right now and there's hairs in the sink.
Oh, that'd be so great. We should troll you.
Some weird Donnie Darko film.
Throw some hairs in the sink real quick with Joey when he goes in.
Got it.
All right, cool. That would be so awesome to just gaslight you like that and then go, dude, we'll go in and see it. And then it would be gone.
Guys, I swear to God, there's hair in this sink.
That would be so great. Oh, man. All right, by the way, the answer is light. That's the energy that you can see. You want to see yourself beating Steve, then you better call this number, 206-803-ROCK. We're playing Beat Migs. Going to do that at 847 on The Rock.
Today's podcast was brought to you by Travis Gagne, bankruptcy attorney. He's here right now and has agreed to answer more of your questions about bankruptcy. Here's a question from a listener. My house is currently in foreclosure. I've stopped making payments. What can I do to save my house?
If you're already in foreclosure behind on your mortgage, you can stop the foreclosure by filing a bankruptcy.
There's different types of bankruptcy. Chapter 13 can help you catch up on your house payments if you're behind. It would mean that you'd have to start making your house payments again and catch up on the amount that you're behind over 5 years. You could also take off or strip off your second mortgage, which would help you to reduce your housing payment every month, especially once you're done with the plan and done catching up on your first mortgage. We could also try to buy you some time by filing a Chapter 13 case. Filing a Chapter 13 would definitely stop your foreclosure.
Thanks, Travis. If you have more questions about bankruptcy, you can reach out to Travis anytime at ChooseTheRightChapter.com. That's ChooseTheRightChapter.com. And thanks for listening.
Ever notice how feline family members take a back seat to dogs by most pet insurance companies? Yeah, that chafes me. Cats have feelings too, and it's just wrong. But hold your horses. I got some good news here. FelixCatInsurance.com is doing something about it. And they call it whisker-to-tail protection. Because, look, our cats don't actually have 9 lives, and accidents and things can happen anytime. Felix Cat Insurance has plan options for cats of all ages, and it covers accidents, illnesses, emergency care, and more. Best part? Plans start at under $1 per day. Customizable coverage exclusively for felines. FelixCatInsurance.com. No dogs allowed. Well, hold up. This ain't over yet. Roll that legal stuff.
Insurance is underwritten by Independence American Insurance Company and produced by Independence Pet Group. Pre-existing conditions are not covered. For all terms and limitations, visit FelixCatInsurance.com/terms.
From the very beginning, your kids mean everything to you. That means you do anything for them, especially if they're at risk. So when it comes to type 1 diabetes, screen it like you mean it. Because even if just one person in the family has it, your child is up to 15 times more likely to get it, too. Screen it like you mean it. Because type 1 diabetes can develop at any age. And once you get results, you can get prepared for your child's future. So screen it like you mean it. Type 1 starts long before there are symptoms. But one blood test could help you spot it early, before they need insulin, and could lower the risk of serious complications like diabetic ketoacidosis or DKA. Talk to your doctor about how to screen for type 1 diabetes, because the more you know, the more you can do. So don't wait. Tap now or visit screenfortype1.com to learn more. Again, that's screenfortype1.com. Screen it like you mean it.
Some companies are big, others are small. To Robert Half, their hiring needs are equally huge. At Robert Half, our specialized recruiting professionals elevate their expertise with proprietary AI tools to transform candidate discovery, assessment, and selection. Whether sourcing talent locally or in any geography that works for you, Robert Half can pinpoint hard-to-find candidates in finance and accounting, technology, marketing and creative, legal, and administrative and customer support. At Robert Half, we know talent.
Transit is better with an Orca card. Here's why. One, it's easy. Just tap and pay your way onto Metro and all other public transit around the Sound. Two, your tap shows us when and where you're riding the most, so Metro can serve you better. And three, Orca cards are for everyone. 18 and younger now ride free with a free youth Orca card. So what are you waiting for? Get an Orca card, tap for transit, and make your ride count today. Visit kingcounty.gov/tap for transit.
Have you or a loved one been injured in an accident? Are you struggling to recover fair compensation? Look no further. At Phillips Law Firm, the experienced personal injury attorneys will fight for your rights and get you the justice and compensation you deserve. They handle a wide range of cases, including car accidents, slip and falls, medical malpractice, and workplace injuries. Justice is a phone call away, so don't wait. Call today for a free case review. Call 1-800-JUSTICE or visit justiceforyou.com.
Looking to give the gift of pleasure? Add a little high heat to keep the desire burning. Or maybe you just need a little self-care. Come to Lovers for the best lingerie and toys to keep things hot this holiday. Save 20% on your purchase with Lovers Afterglow Rewards. Just mention LOVE20 at one of our 18 Western Washington locations. Offer valid with free Lovers Afterglow Rewards membership until November 30th. Some exclusions apply.
Your home is going into foreclosure and you feel like a financial wreck. you don't know where to turn for accurate information. I'm bankruptcy attorney Travis Gagne. Let's talk about some legal options. If we work quickly, we can propose a plan to save your home, modify the loan, or in many cases, even eliminate your second mortgage. The consultation is free. I've helped hundreds of people just like you make informed decisions about whether to save their home or exit it on a reasonable, organized timeline. The chapter you choose sets the tone for the next chapter of your life. Please contact me today at ChooseTheRightChapter.com. That's ChooseTheRightChapter.com.
99.9 KISW, the Rock of Seattle. It's our loud and local band of the week, Green Apple Quickstep. Listening to the loud and local band of the week, Green Apple Quickstep. You want to find out their music? Just check out the BJ and Migs page of KISW.com.
A lot of people are very familiar with this band over the years. A staple here in the Northwest scene. And they're back together again doing a big reunion show. It's going to be happening tomorrow night at El Corazon.
And don't forget Sunday nights, 8 o'clock. Two solid hours of great Pacific Northwest music. Bands like Green Apple Quickstep.
Because we made it. It's Friday.
Hey, Daddy's
If you happen to be in Portland this weekend and want to see Danny jumping in real life, he's DJing Emo Night tonight.
Look at the Portland connection.
PDX Emo.
Yes.
Keeping it weird and emotional.
Are you going to play some Everclear?
I should, really.
Yes.
Oh, yeah, Santa Monica. Better.
Let's do that.
Come on, for art.
Joe, remind me to play Santa Monica.
You're going
to
have this guy remind you?
Yeah.
You need somebody to remind Joe.
Yeah. That's a great
Sarah,
point.
Are you going?
No, I actually wasn't invited.
Yeah, no.
So. I am going to next week's, though, whether Danny invites me or not, because it's in Seattle. So. Right.
Yeah, I just let the security guards know to watch out for the drunk one.
Yeah.
You should wear a wig.
I should.
Because they probably have you on, like, their list.
Right? The one really blonde girl.
Yeah.
Who's always with Danny.
Yeah. Well, at an emo night, you might be one of the few really blonde girls.
Yes, true. That's the problem.
Yep. You stand out.
I should just get a brunette or like maybe a black wig.
Yeah. Lock it up, girl.
Make it edgy. Let's get to our contestant today. We have Thomas from Oak Harbor. Thomas, are you there?
Good morning, KSW.
Good morning.
I'm ready for my BJ.
Awesome.
All right, Thomas.
All right, Steve,
Thomas.
Get out of here.
Give it to you.
Whoa.
For those playing at home, Thomas has 60 seconds to answer 10 questions. You can pass all you want, but you only get 3 guesses per question. Are you ready?
Let's do it.
Joy, sadness, anger, fear, and disgust are all characters from what computer animated movie?
Elemental?
No.
Pass.
What collectible trading card game is abbreviated to MTG?
Magic the Gathering?
Yes. Nice. The Boys Are Back in Town was a 70s hit song by what band?
Boys Are Back in Town.
What is the main alcohol in a Paloma cocktail?
Vodka?
No.
Gin?
No.
Brandy?
No. What is the scientific name for push or pull?
Leverage?
No.
Friction?
No.
Pass.
Which U.S. state exports the most wine?
Washington.
No.
California.
Yes. Mick Jagger was born on July 26th, 1943. So how old is he today?
90?
No.
80.
80.
Nice
yes.
Work.
And with that, you get three correct, Thomas.
Oh, Thomas. Thomas, the little train engine that couldn't. Yeah, what are you going to do?
He sure tried, though.
He did. I'll give him credit, man.
I've been with three before. So.
All right, well, good. Let's hope that's what this is, then.
Let's
a
hope.
Good old-fashioned beating.
Steve, are you ready?
Let's go!
That's too soon.
Joy, sadness, anger, fear, and disgust are characters from what computer animated movie?
War Games.
No.
War Games. I don't know. Computer animated movie. The Tales of Anger, Sadness, People.
No.
Fritz the Cat.
No. What collectible trading card game is abbreviated to MTG?
Magic the Gathering.
Yes. Yes. The Boys Are Back in Town was a 70s hit song by what band?
The Boys Are Back in Town. I don't even know who sang that. Kenny Loggins?
No.
No, sir.
Oh, crap. Bob Seger?
No.
No, sir.
I'm
not going to do it.
The Replacements.
Yeah, no.
No. What is the main alcohol in a Paloma cocktail?
Vodka?
No.
Tequila?
Yes.
Nice work.
What is the scientific name for push or pull?
Force.
Yes.
Nice work.
Which U.S. Ooh. State exports the most wine?
California.
Yes. Mick Jagger was born on July 26, 1943. So how old is he today?
Oh, crap. 80?
Yes.
Nice.
What two colors are Freddy Krueger's original sweater?
Green and red.
Yes. And with that, you get six correct, which is a win, 6-3.
Yeah, buddy. Oh,
sorry, Thomas.
Oh, good job, Steve. Yeah.
Thank you, my friend. Have a great weekend.
Got you that time, he did. All right.
I was a little nervous with the first question there. I didn't think you were going to get six correct.
I'm having a little bit of a streak of starting off red rotten and then turning it around.
You're like the Seahawks, man.
Really?
That's right.
Yep.
I'm a fourth quarter team.
Finish it up on the second half, baby.
Joy, sadness, anger, fear, and disgust are characters from what theater animated movie?
I know the movie. I watched the movie. Can't think of the title.
Inside Out.
Oh,
yes.
Dang it.
Those emotions are inside of you.
Yeah.
The Boys Are Back
Great
in Town.
Song. That's Thin Lizzy.
Yes.
Thin Lizzy. I could not think of it, man.
Yeah.
The Boys Are Back in Town. It's actually a pretty good song. I like it.
Dude, it's a timeless song.
Yeah.
It is funny.
Has anyone ever covered that? Like,
I think so.
A mainstream type band?
Oh, that I don't know.
I'm sure a million bands have covered it.
It has to have been covered, though, by somebody. Yeah. Don't know, though, Steve, as far as mainstream. But yeah, that I would like to hear a mainstream band do it because it's a good tune.
Yeah, I feel like that's probably how I know it.
Bon Jovi, I guess.
Oh, really?
Everclear, oddly enough.
I don't know that.
Danny, play it tonight.
The hell?
I don't think I've heard that version, Everclear's version of The Boys Are Back in Town.
Dude, how old? This is going to make you feel old, though. It's not like they just recently did it. They did it 24 years ago in 1999.
Wow.
World.
I bet Everclear nailed it. I could be wrong.
Yeah.
I bet they did, too.
But I feel... Is the Everclear version?
It's okay.
I was expecting a little crunchier.
Yeah.
It's not bad.
It's okay. I think Art's voice is, I'm not sure it's the right voice for the song.
Well, let's hear the chorus. Maybe that's where he picks it up.
Okay. No.
How about Funeral for a Friend? Isn't that like a metal band?
It was an emo band.
Emo band? Okay.
Emo, like, screaming.
They covered it. I don't know if you can find that one. Also, Belle and Sebastian, which were like a really mellow, kind of quiet group. They covered it. The Cardigans?
I don't know the Cardigans.
Oh, man. They had a popular song in the late 90s. It was like...
Okay. Yeah.
I can't remember the name of the song.
Now that name sounds familiar, the band, but I don't know the song you're talking about.
Yeah, the Cardigans were a pretty cool band, though.
All right, then. Yeah.
Love Fool. Love me.
Oh!
Tell that you love me.
That's right.
And they also have my favorite game.
Here's the Funeral for a Friend version.
I bet it's a little heavier. I like this.
Yeah. His voice is better for this song. Yeah, sometimes, man, you know, I think a band, even though a band likes a song, I think the singer's got to know if it's like, if your voice is right for it. I know you guys are not as big Bowling for Soup fans as I am.
Oh, you're a card-carrying club, fan club member.
But, I mean, they cover a lot of stuff. They've covered, like, they've covered Flock of Seagulls, Iran. They covered the Eagles song, Already Gone. And his voice is like, no, dude, it doesn't belong in either one of those songs, really.
Are you going to go see Bowling for Soup next week, BJ?
I didn't even know they were in town.
They are. I believe it's next Wednesday.
Who are they coming with? They got to be coming with some people, right?
Messed.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I know you wouldn't know any of them.
You played with them once.
I did play with Mest.
I remember
once.
That.
Yeah. I'm actually going for Mest. I don't really care about Bowling for Soup.
Isn't it great on a weeknight when a band that you like is the opener for a band that you just, like, you're not dislike, but you're just indifferent about? That way you know you're going to have a decently early night.
If Bowling for Soup was here on a Saturday, I would stay the whole time. They're here on a Wednesday. I'm not staying the whole time.
Yeah, that's the problem.
Yeah.
It's looking like it's on a Tuesday.
Oh, Tuesday. Sorry.
Oh, that's a whole different story.
Even worse.
Yeah, even worse.
Yeah, that's Tuesday's nuts. Yeah. Sorry, Bowling for Soup. I'm not that big of a fan.
Aww.
Even though they sang a song about your girl, Alexa Bliss.
They did. I know. That is very cool.
Yeah.
The wrestler.
All right. It is time for you. Yep. It's time for you to pick the topic, you to guide the show. Call us, text us, 206-803-ROCK. It's Listeners on the Loose. Your calls and texts at 917 on The Rock.
BJ and Migs, mornings on The Rock, 99.9
KISW, The Rock of Seattle. It's Listeners on the Loose, brought to you by Kia of Puyallup. 206-803-ROCK, the number to call, the number to text for Listeners on the Loose. Remember, Steve has a rule.
It's a simple rule, BJ, that's to show some energy and bring it. Otherwise, we're going to have to gong you. And then say goodbye.
Goodbye, old friend.
206-803-ROCK, the number to call, the number to text.
Someone wanted a quick question, a quick update about your son, Joe. They said, hey, wait, can you guys go over it? How did Joe manage to land a girlfriend? I somehow missed this.
Oh, well, who wants to tell the story? Who can tell it the quickest or the best?
Well, I mean, Joe really doesn't have a girlfriend. We're just making this all up.
It's a sordid tale.
I think Joe should share the story.
All right, Joe, what do you tell people?
It's his story, after all.
Well, a quick recap. I met this woman a year ago at boot camp, and we went back this year in August.
And for those that don't know, our radio convention is called boot camp. It's not like Joe decided to join the military.
I joined the military to get a girlfriend?
Morning show boot camp.
Yes.
If you don't know, you're probably like, wait, now Joe's in the military and he has a girlfriend?
Yes. Yeah. So you met this girl a year ago at the convention.
And she had a boyfriend at the time. I met her again this year in Dallas in August, and she didn't have a boyfriend. We reconnected, hit it off during the convention, and then kept dating via FaceTime and other apps and hung out a bunch and texted. And eventually our relationship developed into something real. And so now we're boyfriend and girlfriend.
And it's so weird.
Long distance, baby.
It's a long distance relationship. And I mean, nowadays with technology, it can happen.
Do you like it being long distance, or do you wish that you were closer?
I think now I like it long distance, but sooner, as time goes on, I like it more that she would be here or I'd be there. But
wow.
Is it because you just like to be able to still be Joe and do Joe things? And if you had a girlfriend, you're afraid that you wouldn't be able to do Joe things?
You know, I do have a lot of things I like to do that, I don't know if necessarily would be able to happen if there was less time involved and I'd spend more time with her. But
and hooking up with other ladies is not one of them,
though. They can't do that. No, okay. That's definitely frowned upon.
Okay, just making sure, because when you make it sound like, well, if she was here, I couldn't do these things anymore.
When you put it that way, Steve, that's a good sentence to add. I appreciate that.
Was it her or you that decided this is serious?
I originally wanted it to be more serious, but we kind of wanted to take it slow because, like, I've never been in a long-distance relationship, and it is definitely different. But she was the one that wanted to make it more serious after a couple months.
Nice.
Yeah.
She realized she just can't. She can't resist the Joe.
Well, after I flew down, to visit her that one time, I think that really solidified the relationship.
Dang. It's so wild, man.
Yeah.
It's a wild way to go. And
especially when there's not this doesn't sound good, but there's no light at the end of the tunnel. In a sense, like, at some point she's moving here or you're moving there. You guys are just going to be a long distance relationship until one of you has to make that decision.
Pretty much. Yeah. But I don't want to think about that.
Okay.
Thanks, Steve.
It just gave him instant anxiety.
Well, I mean, someone has to think about it, right?
Well, look, let's leave that for, you know, future Joey. You know, current Joey's having a great time.
When should future Joey get involved in this conversation?
That's another problem for future Joey to decide.
Has she mentioned anything? Am I asking too much? Please shut me down.
You're starting to sound like his mother, actually.
Am I?
And his sister.
Joseph.
Oh, Sarah hasn't stopped.
Sarah, get in here. Maybe you have some more questions that I'm not even asking. Oh,
I'm very proud of myself because I just know to leave him alone.
Yeah.
I don't know if my wife and my daughter understand that.
No, she's a planner, so she constantly brings it up. And she's like, well, what do you think? What do you think? And I, you know me, I'm easygoing. I'm like, you know, I don't want to put any labels or anything on it right now. So, you know. But then we did put labels on it, and now.
Yeah.
There's a label on it.
Well, I just think at some point one of you is going to be like, hey, I can't keep dating you from a distance. I kind of want to see you more often.
That's true. I mean, it could end that way. I don't know. It's one of those things where it's just so
taking it day by day.
Yeah, and it's new. Fair. And you know, people have told me, I've talked to some of the people who have been in long distance relationships, and they say it can last a long time before you get to that point. So
we had a former intern, Tahiti Steve, who had a long distance relationship for the longest time, and they're still married. They finally got together and they are still married.
How long were they long distance for?
Vicky can tell you.
I want to say like 4 years.
4 years?
Like it was basically from the time we moved in till I was moved out. I moved out like shortly after they got married.
Yeah, four.
So maybe even longer
it
than
was
that.
It was at least 4 years.
Yeah.
And I couldn't, you know, because I'm old school. Like, there's no way you're going to, I mean, it's one thing to be long distance if you've already been together for a while and maybe you got to do it. But I know military couples figure this out. But man, oh man, first timers like that, I just, and he made it work.
I mean, he's like a pro baseball player. You're on the road all the time. That's
but you also, though.
Is there a professional wrestler on the road for 300 days of the year?
But they got some cash that you can fly out when you want, and he will be with them on the off season. There's no off season for this with Joe.
There's no off season for 80s era wrestlers either.
All right, I thought about that.
Yeah, I don't think the girl that Joey is with now is going to be as patient as Tahiti Steve.
What do you think? A year?
If that. If that.
So do you think your brother is going to be pulled to North Carolina?
Yeah, I thought about it. Oh, Joe, I miss you so much. But, I mean, you got to do what you got to do for love.
Who's well, it depends on who has the most, you know, who's got the job.
I'm hoping she comes here.
Yeah. Right now, they both, because she works in radio, too, and looks like she's got a job. Joe's got a job. So what's going to give?
You know what you should do is do city roulette. Just kind of pick a city, put it on a wheel, or a bunch of cities, put it on a wheel, and then you guys just move to a mutual city.
What about a city that's like halfway from us to North Carolina?
That, too.
Okay, first of all, and Danny, Danny is just an eye in the sky. Yeah, let's just do that. And where will they get work?
I don't know. You figure that out when you get there.
I don't know.
Walmart.
Figure it out when you get there.
Yeah.
Let's just move to a city. Bills will not be a problem.
Yeah, that's how all the great, like, young romantic comedies start, right?
Yeah, don't listen to Danny, Joe.
No, listen to me.
I do have a question, though, Joe.
Oh, God.
So it's been, what, a month and a half-ish? Right?
For this long-distance relationship that Joey Deese is in.
Almost 2 months.
Almost 2 months.
Almost 2 months, this long-distance relationship.
Have you guys dropped the L word yet?
No.
Who?
I don't believe.
Look, okay.
The pause.
Okay.
The pause!
So,
oh boy. I'm not talking about like linguine. We're talking about the other
it's
L word.
It's always awkward because if it gets dropped and the other person doesn't drop it back, that's a beating.
I remember the first time I told my wife the L word and she just replied with, thank you.
Yeah, that's not a good response.
That's cool. That's cool.
Not going to, no further questions.
Yeah.
I'll wait.
I got news for you. It's better that way at least because the other way around, you can't come back from that. If the guy, if the girl drops it on you and you say thank you, it's almost over.
Oh, no. I was just like, whatever.
Yeah.
She'll love me eventually. Yeah. Everybody does.
You're like, this is my goal in life. Yeah.
Even my daughter for the longest time just would say thanks. I'm like, Tatum, I love you. Thanks.
Come on, take after her.
Yeah,
seriously,
I know.
It's like, really? Did your mom teach you that?
I was like, you know, there's a proper response.
You can drop the L word.
Thanks,
Dad.
Yeah,
come on.
I helped bring you into this world.
Yeah, you did,
and I'll take you. Well, not that crazy.
Oh, okay,
all right. So well, no love.
Well, so Joe, see, I'm a linguine person, Steve. She's more of a penne person right now. But the reason for that is...
So you love her and she...
And she calls you what? Pumpkin?
Passion?
Yeah, I'm not sure. So did you drop the linguine and she didn't drop it back?
No, she thinks that when we say it, it should be in person, not like over the phone or something like that. Which I think is a good Okay. Good choice, yeah.
So what are you going to see her at the end of the month?
Yeah, so we'll know by October 31st.
Oh, yeah. If she loves you. Like, yes. What, are you going to go trick-or-treat I love you?
Yeah, that's how you do it.
It's not a bad idea.
Reach into a bag, you get candy or a love.
So you love her.
Oh, don't bring it. Don't make it say it.
I'm a linguine guy. That's all I'm saying.
Okay, so when you see her
after only 2 months,
the end of this month,
he's falling hard.
You're gonna drop the L word, and then the ball's in her court.
Yeah,
odds are good. Yeah, I'm a betting man. If Vegas had odds, I'd say yeah, I'd bet on that.
You guys,
how well did your bets go in Vegas when we all went?
Not
there?
Great.
Yeah.
Pretty terrible.
Honestly,
I think she'll say it back.
Oh yeah.
I am shocked.
I think she is I think she's waiting to be able to say it in person, but probably already feels the exact same way.
I am so shocked at the development of this. I've never seen my son like this in the history of his life.
Right. It's blowing both of your minds. I can tell.
I'm so excited for him. I'm like grinning ear to ear. This is so precious.
I don't know why.
Like, how do you feel? I feel like that 40-year... you guys getting together at age 40 is not going to happen.
No, I'm okay with this because I am super excited. I would have lost money on this bet because he's always kind of close to the vest. He doesn't really seem to like open up and be out there with the ladies unless it's, you know, drunk and
outside.
You're sweating
like crap. We had 40. We did make this agreement.
It's like, yeah. Oh, 45. Let's move it up to 45, 50. No. So I'm excited because I feel like the wedding's going to be even before then. I'm calling it now.
Whoa, that's a lot of pressure.
If they're already about to drop the L word after 2 months.
I don't think that's that crazy.
I'm not thinking about weddings. I'm not even thinking about destinations right now.
Yeah, I don't blame you, son. That's 2 months seems to...
I can't judge at all. But considering this is like, he hasn't had a relationship in, I don't even know if ever. This is like...
This is the first we've all heard of a relationship with Joe.
Yeah. So,
and I don't think we would have known had she not worked in the same industry and we saw them making out.
Exactly.
Like, saw them making out because somebody recorded it.
Hey, well, I needed proof.
All of Dallas saw them make out.
Yeah, that's true.
And I have a feeling that he wouldn't have told us and he probably would have made up stories for why he's going somewhere in October.
Well, he did that with me. Told me he was going hiking. Didn't tell me where he was going hiking.
In North Carolina.
Yeah, that was,
one of my better kept secrets.
Do you think the job's going to be the place that brings them to wherever they go? I don't know.
Yeah, it's hard to say.
It's going to be love, man.
I feel like, it's the you-know-what-ski that's going to tell him where he wants to go. Okay.
Wow.
The linguine, if you will.
The linguine. Yeah, he heard that the linguine in North Carolina are some of the best best linguinis that you could ever get.
That's it. Okay, then.
God.
Yeah.
Someone said, at this rate, Joe's going to have a kid before Sarah.
That's what we've been thinking. It's very possible.
Yeah, because I've heard she has quite the baby fever.
Yeah, and
you where'd you hear that?
From
her.
From her.
Yeah.
I know. This is not good.
Don't be planting those images.
Yeah, I know.
So we might have a little one in August.
All right, hold on. Joey D's.
Is that 9 months from now?
Do not forget that conversation.
October 31st.
Yeah. Oh.
Do not forget that conversation we had in the garage when you were a teenager about how to protect yourself against having babies you don't want to have. It
double
still
applies. Saran wrap. I remember.
It still applies.
Captain America's shield.
Yeah, whatever. It still applies, Joe. Wait till you get married before you even think about the bebis.
I'm such a terrible influence, though, because I'm like, so I'm going down to visit her as well at the end of this month with my husband.
Well, I can't.
This is a chance to ruin the relationship. That's the thing.
I know,
this
but...
the strangest reality show that no cameras are following.
I'm such a bad influence that, like, I'm probably going to be like, Sarah, girl, we should get pregnant together. Like, let's just...
Poor Joe.
I could see that actually happening.
Yeah!
I mean, it is at this point, this is what's going to happen.
Oh, God,
Joey would become an uncle and a father.
Yeah, and I would...
At the same time.
And I would become... Both kids will have their buddies.
They would be the best of friends and best of cousins.
That's what Tatum and her cousin are. They're like sisters. They even call themselves sisters.
Oh, see, this could be amazing, actually.
Nope.
Yep.
No, thank you.
Yeah, so we'll see.
Well,
we'll see what the conversation is.
I'll tell you what, it's time for me to move somewhere.
Just not North Carolina or Seattle.
I don't care. No one's going to know where I'm going to move if we're going to have two kids bopping in the world.
So it says, Dan, this poor guy's getting called out in all the areas.
It surely is.
Yeah.
And not by his father.
We have lots of questions.
Yeah, not his father. His father understands, you know what, respect the man's pace, his privacy, and how he conducts his life.
Do you approve of the woman that he has chosen to fall in linguine with?
I don't. I only had a small conversation with her, and she seemed very nice.
Yes.
Yeah. And of course we have to ask all the questions. This is like the most shocking thing ever, that Joe's in a relationship
He had a long distance one.
God, he's not an experiment. He's a human being. You know,
are we sure of that?
Yeah. Well,
am I an alien?
Yeah. All right. Well, you pick the topic. You guide the show. It is, well, really, Joey D's on the loose. Call us or text us at 206-803-ROCK. Whatever you want to talk about, your calls and texts at 9:35 on The Rock.
BJ and Migs, mornings on The Rock, 99.9 KISW.
This holiday season, make your journey memorable with Travel Centers of America. Visit our one-stop shop for all your holiday travel needs. Fuel up, get snacks, and dine at one of our full-service restaurants. Hit the road with peace of mind knowing we've got you covered. Travel Centers of America.
Ever notice how feline family members take a back seat to dogs by most pet insurance companies? Yeah, that chafes me. Cats have feelings too, and it's just wrong. But hold your horses. I got some good news here. FelixCatInsurance.com is doing something about it. And they call it whisker-to-tail protection. Because, look, our cats don't actually have nine lives, and accidents and things can happen anytime. Felix Cat Insurance has plan options for cats of all ages, and it covers accidents, illnesses, emergency care, and more. Best part? Plans start at under $1 per day. Customizable coverage exclusively for felines. FelixCatInsurance.com. No dogs allowed. Well, hold up. This ain't over yet. Roll that legal stuff.
Insurance is underwritten by Independence American Insurance Company and produced by Independence Pet Group. Pre-existing conditions are not covered. For all terms and limitations, visit felixcatinsurance.com/terms.
From the very beginning, your kids mean everything to you. That means you do anything for them, especially if they're at risk. So when it comes to type 1 diabetes, screen it like you mean it. Because even if just one person in the family has it, your child is up to 15 times more likely to get it, too. Screen it like you mean it. Because type 1 diabetes can develop at any age. And once you get results, you can get prepared for your child's future. So screen it like you mean it. Type 1 starts long before there are symptoms. But one blood test could help you spot it early, before they need insulin, and could lower the risk of serious complications like diabetic ketoacidosis or DKA. Talk to your doctor about how to screen for type 1 diabetes, because the more you know, the more you can do. So don't wait. Tap now or visit screenfortype1.com to learn more. Again, that's screenfortype1.com. Screen it like you mean it.
Transit is better with an Orca card. Here's why. One, it's easy. Just tap and pay your way onto Metro and all other public transit around the Sound. Two, your tap shows us when and where you're riding the most, so Metro can serve you better. And three, Orca cards are for everyone. 18 and younger now ride free with a free youth Orca card. So what are you waiting for? Get an Orca card, tap for transit, and make your ride count today. Visit kingcounty.gov/tap for transit.
99.9 KISW, The Rock of Seattle. Listeners on the loose, 206-803-ROCK, the number to call, the number to text. I want to give a shout-out, if I can, to my buddy Josh, who, he had an accident at work yesterday. He might need surgery on his hand, and, whew, yeah, he, man, wasn't a great day for him yesterday as he was trying to get the medical system to help him out, too. Lots of runarounds, but speedy healing, buddy.
Yeah, that sucks.
Yeah, that's, dang, I'll tell you, man. Just goes to show you what happens when somebody who, somebody who actually works for a living, you know, can have stuff like that happen. That, you know, I might get a paper cut from a board game. That might be the worst thing that can happen to me.
Paper cuts suck.
They do.
Not to go to the hospital for them, but they do suck.
206-803-ROCK, the number to call, the number to text. PJ in Seattle, you're on The Rock.
PJ, actually.
Is it P as in Paul? J as in Joseph?
Like Pearl Jam? No.
T as in Tom.
Oh, TJ. T as in Tommy.
Yeah. No, I'm just calling in that I'm going to date myself here, that me and my wife met back in 2008, July, on MySpace.
Oh.
And about 4 months later, she moved in with me. I was stationed up at Fort Lewis. And we've been together ever since.
Whoa, that's back in 08. Good for you.
How soon did it take for you to put her in your top eight on MySpace?
about 3 weeks.
Nice.
That's fantastic, TJ.
She's number one.
Yeah, and all the other girls were off the top eight. They were just back down to whatever else.
All right, so that's good news for Joey D's, is that Yeah, and it's gonna be, the trouble is they both have jobs, and one of them is going to have to, you know, move to the other to, and then try to find a job.
Yeah,
and then the question is, can that one person support both of them until that happens? If indeed that's the question, or if you're Danny, don't worry about money, just move wherever you want to.
Both of you quit and just find a random place to live.
Yeah, exactly. Let Linguini lead the way, and you all find jobs eventually.
I hope Danny's girlfriend's in charge of the money in this family.
Of course not.
That's bad.
I actually have a new plan now.
Oh, wow. In 5 minutes, you came up with a new plan?
All right, here we go.
I'm in.
My buddy texted me, and he suggested if I just win the Powerball on Saturday, all my problems will be solved.
True.
Dude, we could all move with you. We could just buy like a commune.
Oh, yeah. We'll buy an island.
Yeah. I'll take that. And I guess it's all about Joey Deez's long-distance relationship. It's been almost two months.
And so I have a similar story, and I think it's pretty cool. Me and my girlfriend met when I was living in Iowa, came back to Washington from my best friend's wedding, hit it off with his wife's sister. We did long distance for about 8 months, and she wanted to make things serious. I turned it into a boyfriend-girlfriend situation. I then moved back to Washington, and we've been together ever since.
So the question I have for this person, and this is the one, like, yeah, you guys were hanging out on the internet, and it looked like after 8 months you made it serious. So did you have other people? Because these two are, from what I understand, they are keeping it monogamous pretty much ever since they met each other again, you know, 2 months ago. That's difficult.
They met each other over a year ago.
Right. And she was with somebody.
Right.
But they definitely hit it off and decided we are liking each other 2 months ago. And, boy, it is tough to be monogamous and, you know, have that trust and all that when you don't have that physical contact that, you know, a new relationship would love to have.
I do have a very important question for Joe, and a favor, if I may ask.
Okay.
So you're going to North Carolina at the end of the month to see your lady.
Yes.
There is a bar called the Pig Pounder Brewery. Can you please get me a t-shirt from there?
I will get you 4 t-shirts from that place.
Thank you. Then I fully support and approve of your relationship.
The Pig Pounder Brewery. Look at this.
The Pig Pounder Brewery. I need a t-shirt.
Well, if that's anywhere near them, hopefully it doesn't have to drive too far to get to it. North Carolina is a big state.
Greensboro.
Oh, that's right where we are.
Oh.
Like 15 minutes away.
Look at this place. This place looks amazing. It actually looks like a cool spot.
Yeah.
You can even throw axes in there.
Nice. Oh, look at that. Plus, you got pigs. What's that, Pig's Pounder?
Pig Pounder.
Oh, okay. There you go.
They got good hats?
Oh.
I got a great logo with a pig on it.
That's all you need.
Size large, please.
Done.
I'll Venmo you.
Okay, then.
I'll buy two just in case.
You know, I'll buy you a beer while we're at it, too, while you're there.
Oh,
you know
what? What a guy. Yeah. Go to Pig Pounder.
I knew Steve was a cool guy.
And you know what? Some linguine from there, too.
That looks like a place that Jay Rubs would like to go to, so you're doing him a favor, too.
That is funny. One texter did bring up a good point. Wait a second. Are we glossing over the fact that his second date with this woman, basically his sister and her husband are coming along?
Yeah, that's Sarah, the double date lady. Sarah likes to be everywhere. She wants to be in everybody's business.
Can I ask a question about that, Joe?
Sure.
Did your sister invite herself, or did you invite her?
Okay, what do you think the answer is?
I know the answer. That's why I'm asking.
That's correct. Sarah did invite herself.
Of course she did.
The mastermind of this whole plan.
Yeah.
It turns out that she talked to my significant other behind my back to set up this trip, invited herself to the trip, and then I got the conversation of, you should come down for Halloween.
You realize you could just tell your sister no, right?
Yeah. No.
You know,
no, you can't.
How nice is it? The family already approves of her, wants to hang out with her. This is you've jumped many good hurdles.
Yeah, and she's already met BJ, my significant other.
And
so,
still is with you.
And you know, I feel like we've jumped enough hurdles, like you said, that you know this relationship is bound to work out.
I did a good job. I didn't chase her away, which is pretty amazing for me.
You only ate her meatballs. That's the only thing you did.
They were my meatballs, too.
Well, did you give her any?
I can't remember. There was a lot going on. Really? I owe her some meatballs? Really? God, I feel badly about that. I guess I did take the plate over to a different table to give them some time.
You ordered some meatballs and you took them from her?
That was a chaotic day at that restaurant.
It was.
It really was. I don't know whose meatballs. I was just eating food. And you know what? Those two are all romantic.
You're eating your son's girlfriend's meatballs.
You kick me to another table. You want my son? I get the meatballs. Okay? I think a fair transaction. There you go. That's my story. I'm sticking to it. Sorry, son. Well, even when I ate her meatballs, she stayed with him.
You didn't do what Sarah did, which was in front of the woman's brunch, exclaim at the top of her lungs, "Did you have sex with my brother?" So you didn't do that.
No, I didn't. And I was at the woman's brunch. And again, It's nice to know that Sarah's carrying the mantle being the idiot of conventions, because that used to be my job, and you know what? I passed the torch off to her.
So she said that at the brunch that was celebrating women in radio.
Yes.
She's like, did you have sex with my brother?
Well, that's part of a celebration in radio, right? If you get lucky, isn't that something to celebrate?
And it was such a small room.
Yeah, it was.
Everyone heard.
Yeah, everybody knew
and
what was
I
going
didn't
on.
Know until I walked in, and I was like, why is everyone looking at me funny?
Well, because you were the lucky one.
Man, you can't pick a better place to ask that question.
Sarah loves public places and awkward questions.
Clearly.
Yeah. It is Listeners on the Loose, 206-803-ROCK, the number to call, the number to text.
All right, somebody, a few people have been texting in. Apparently earlier we upset a few people, BJ.
Did we?
Someone says, I have to admit that sometimes it's painful listening to this show. You guys need a music expert with you. Yes, BJ, the Benny Hill music is the song Yakety Sax. Steve, you're thinking about a song called Yakety Yak. They're two different songs. We got so many texts from people like, guys, you're arguing over two different songs, you idiots.
Oh, so you don't talk. Yeah, you know what? That makes sense because Yakety Sax is the
That's Yakety Sax.
Oh, and Yakety Yak is a 50s tune,
yes.
Isn't it? Yeah.
This.
Don't talk back.
Take out the papers. Yes. And the
that sounds like I don't remember any.
Well, there is a sax in there.
Is that a sax?
Yes, that's the sax.
All right.
Yeah. At least I think that's a sax.
Don't talk about it.
Wow, you know what? You're right. We are idiots.
Yes.
Thank you for correcting us, textures. You're absolutely right. At least I got the Benny Hill song
like
right.
4 minutes arguing over a song when it was two completely different songs.
You know, every once in a while, you catch us being stupid, and you did.
Every once in a while.
I was like, every day.
Every once
talking
in
about?
30 seconds.
Most of the time, I'm pretty spot on, you know.
About what?
Well, it doesn't matter.
Okay, fair.
Yeah, as long as it's so. Yeah, Yakety Yak and Yakety Sax, two different songs. Okay.
Jason.
Hold on. Before the textures, Yakety Yak was never talked about. It was Yakety Sack that was talked about. That's what Steve said. So nobody was wrong about Yakety Yak.
Well, because you said
called Yakety Sack, don't talk back.
You said Yakety Sacks, don't talk back.
Did I say that?
Yes, that's how it all started.
And you said Yakety Sack.
Well, because I heard sacks.
Okay.
So I'm like, wait a second. All this time, I thought it was sacks.
All right. I was wrong about misidentifying two different songs, but there was no Yakety Sack song ever, which was your particular proclamation.
But you started it.
You played
some mental gymnastics with me to think that the word was sack and not yak.
I just wanted to point that out because the Texters forgot to bring up the Yakety Sack. And I think that's an important part of the stupidity.
Yeah, but I would have never thought it if you hadn't said Yakety Sax,
listen,
don't talk back.
I don't care what motivated you and catalyzed that situation, but the fact is Yakety Sax was mentioned. Which, by the way, should be a new song. That needs to be a song somewhere.
That song.
Can we get the There I Ruined It guy on YouTube to combine
Please.
The two songs and turn it into Yakety Sax, don't talk back?
Yes. Yes.
Yeah.
I want that to happen.
I'm not
going
to
so
say
bad.
No to this. Yakety Sack could be a big hit.
He'll be like, look, guys, I've done a lot of stupid mashups and stupid reimagining of songs. This might be the dumbest one.
This is lying. I'm not going to do it.
Yeah, you guys have gone too far. Stop talking about my webpage.
Boy, when there I ruined it, rejects your idea, which, by the way, I remember Bob Rivers rejecting a lot of my ideas for his Twisted Tunes. He invited me to one session and never invited me again because the whole room just kept looking at me like, what the F is wrong with it? No, we're not going to sing that song. Mm. I did have some really bad suggestions that I can't even mention on the radio, but I don't even, they were. I thought they were good.
Someone said Arnold Schwarzenegger, he sang Yakety Yak in the Best in Twins.
What?
Oh, I haven't seen that movie, so I don't know.
Ooh, according to Wikipedia, which we know is always correct, the tenor saxophone used for the Yakety Yak song actually inspired Boots Randolph's song Yakety Sax. So it was inspired
by. Oh, look at the connection.
There is a connection.
Look at the connection. But hold on. What does it say, though, about Yakety Sack? Anything inspired that? No. You know why? Because that was from the mind of a moron.
Steve,
what are the odds that our stupid conversation there is actually one degree of separation?
Yes, there was. So the textures now owe us an apology. We confuse two things that are indeed related.
More importantly, do we have Arnold Schwarzenegger singing Yakety Yak?
Do we really?
I think I do.
Let's hear this from the movie Twins. He's singing Yakety Yak, don't talk back. Oh, I can't wait for it.
Take out the papers and the trash.
Yes.
Oh, my God.
Or you don't get no spending cash.
Oh, my God.
If you don't scrap that kitchen floor, you ain't gonna rock and roll no more. Yakety yak. Don't talk back.
He's on a plane.
Oh. Wow, look how young he is. And, of course, the woman that is helping him take his headphones off happens to be in a strategic position for him to go, I don't care anymore about singing.
That was amazing.
Yeah, that's... It's amazing how far he got with no ability.
What are you talking about?
Really, he was a horrible actor, and somehow he figured it out.
He got by with pure charm and muscles.
Look, you're right. He has charm and he has muscles. But
and hard
God,
work.
Horrible actor. Mm. Oh, my God.
Hard work, baby.
But you know what? I enjoyed his movies. So, look, I contributed to whatever that was. And, well, congratulations to him.
Yuckity yuck.
Don't talk back. I'll throw your bed out the window.
I think we'd do that in the Terminator. Yuckity yuck. I'll be back.
Okay, I'm going to give you know what? I think you've redeemed yourself. That's a nice web redemption you did right there. Good job. All right, well, look, we have an important question that has to be answered right now. What do Ryan Castle and a Ring camera have in common? I'm going to tell you at 9:50 on The Rock.
BJ and Migs, mornings on The Rock, 99.9 KISW. And now... the Ryan Castle question of the day.
What do Ryan Castle and a Ring camera have in common?
I know what's going on outside your house.
Yeah, you are the original Ring camera. Except I never saw the footage that you recorded.
I was in the bushes.
Oh, both have caught him stealing Steve's package.
Okay.
Package.
Package thief.
Steve likes to look at both of them on his phone.
Yeah, he does. Yeah.
All right.
And they're both on sale at Walmart.
Oh.
Ryan Castle, right now, you know what? Save less, live more. It's Ryan Castle.
Adult toy section.
It's a cheap knockoff version of me, though.
Yeah. That's the Ring Ding can. Ring, you know those folks? They're offering to pay you $1 million if your doorbell camera catches actual footage of aliens.
Wow, that seems fair.
It's the $1 million search for extraterrestrials.
Yo, I'll dress up as an alien if he gets us $1 million.
Seems right. Like a real safe promotion on their part.
Hey, guys.
Yeah, can you make it more convincing that that guy down in Mexico presented those, what he said were alien bodies? Can you make it a little bit more convincing
than
that?
I thought those were cake.
Yeah, it looked like cake.
Yeah.
Yeah, so, wow. $1 million if you can get an alien on your Ring cam, but you got only until November 3rd to submit. Yeah, hurry.
I'm going to go buy a lottery ticket instead.
Yeah, you probably have a good idea.
Yeah.
Ryan Castle doesn't have any aliens, but he does have a 12-pack. That's next.
BJ and Migs, mornings on The Rock, 99.9 KISW.
Today's podcast was brought to you by Travis Gagne, bankruptcy attorney. He's here right now and has agreed to answer more of your questions about bankruptcy. Here's another question from a listener. I have a mountain of credit card bills and consumer debt. Can I still keep my house if I file bankruptcy?
Yes, you almost always can keep your home and your house, your car in a bankruptcy. Depending on what type of bankruptcy you file, would depend on whether or not, for example, you can keep your vehicles if you have payments on them still. You can almost always keep your home if you're current on the payments on your home, even in full bankruptcy. In Chapter 13, you can also keep those items. If you're behind on your house, you could catch your house payments up in a Chapter 13, take off a second mortgage in a Chapter 13. So keeping your primary assets like a home and car is almost always possible in bankruptcy.
Thanks, Travis. If you have more questions about bankruptcy, you can reach out to Travis anytime at ChooseTheRightChapter.com. That's ChooseTheRightChapter.com. And thanks for listening.
Some companies are big, others are small. To Robert Half, their hiring needs are equally huge. At Robert Half, our specialized recruiting professionals elevate their expertise with proprietary AI tools to transform candidate discovery, assessment, and selection. Whether sourcing talent locally or in any geography that works for you, Robert Half can pinpoint hard-to-find candidates in finance and accounting, technology, marketing and creative, legal, and administrative and customer support. At Robert Half, we know talent.
When making a real estate purchase, partner with an agent who is a realtor. We're experts in what we do, with access to exclusive tools and proprietary market data. We're Realtors, members of the National Association of Realtors. That's who we are.
hidden fees, restrictive healthcare networks, and confusing coverage are signs that your health insurance isn't really working for you. Christian Healthcare Ministries is the biblical alternative to health insurance, with flexible, affordable healthcare programs and the ability to choose your provider without network restrictions. You can finally have freedom over your healthcare decisions. And when you join, you're surrounded by fellow believers who offer spiritual support. Learn more by visiting chministries.org/solution.
Is your wallet a little lighter than usual after a fun-filled summer? Consider it time and money well spent, because you deserve to live your best life. And the Chime online checking account wants to help you live yours to the fullest. Chime knows a little extra money goes a long way, which is why the Chime checking account has tons of benefits that millions of members love, like fee-free overdraft up to $200 for eligible members, no monthly fees, and access to over 60,000 easy-to-find and fee-free ATMs. You even get paid up to 2 days early with direct deposit, all while managing your money on the go, and there are no credit checks to apply. A banking app that people love? Sign up for Chime today for yourself and your wallet. Get started at chime.com/fee-free. That's chime.com/fee-free. Chime is a financial technology company, not a bank. Banking services and debit card provided by the Bancorp Bank N.A. or Stride Bank N.A., members FDIC. Spot me eligibility requirements and overdraft limits apply. Access to direct deposits up to 2 days early depends on the timing of the submission of the payment file from the payer. Out-of-network ATM withdrawal fees may apply.